everyone, I'm Emily, your community manager here at HyperRPG, and I just wanted to take a second before the show to let you know that we are currently in the midst of a 48-hour charity live stream for the Halo Foundation. It's super fun. We've got 24 hours of RPGs, we've got a dunk tank, we've got celebrity guests, we've got a ton of fun stuff happening, and we need your help to help raise $150,000 to help get kids off the street. I want you to check out twitch.tv/hyperRPG all weekend. We're starting at 11 a.m. Friday, April 7th Pacific time, and then we are going all the way to Sunday, 11 a.m. Pacific time. No sleeping, just crazy. It's gonna be amazing. You should come check it out and help the kids.
Skulls shall be cracked. Dogs shall be neutered. Films that you loved as children will be remade and they'll be terrible, but you'll convince yourself that you love them anyway. You have entered the gauntlet! Ah! Yes, hear the roars, hear the screams of the bloodthirsty spectators in the arena. That is right, everyone, you have entered the gauntlet. A game most dangerous, full of swords and shields and gladiators most foul, where I, Amontioch the Skullgiver, shall test all of the champions of the land of Deros to see if they have the skill, if they have the strength, the stamina, the smarts, and the wherewithal to join my super army. For all of you joining us from the dimension known as Earth, and for all of those spectating in the arena itself in the land of Deros, we do hope that you have a good evening in front of you tonight. But before we get into the blood, the spilling, the guts, the danger, the glory, we must meet our champions! I turn to my left to meet such a champion. You there, champion the first. Describe to those who you are, what is your purpose, why will you win the gauntlet?
My name is Back Crusher, and I come from a professional tribe of backstabbers. I am a rogue, a dirty rogue with two daggers. But my family, my tribe, is just absolutely awful. They are the worst. You cannot trust them. I've left them in order to find a new family.
Yes. For what we are born into is not a choice of ours. But the skills that we gain along the way to perhaps find a new family inside of the walls of the Godland. Yeah. Ah, yes. Champion the first. Champion the second. Describe to the world who you are and why you have found yourself here tonight.
Well, my name is Lyra, and I'm a wood elf from the Forest of Arden. Mm. And I was raised with 12 brothers who were all warrior elves, so I got really good at fighting. But then I realized I didn't want to fight anymore, really. So I studied like the healing arts at this college, but now I'm in really bad debt, like student loan debt. So I'm basically trying to get out of debt, so that's why I want to win the gauntlet today and then not fight anymore and fight in a stupid war. Like, I just want to heal people, you know?
Yes. Why pay off your student debt when you can have a sharp sword and kill things instead? You have that. Yes, indeed. Now there, champion the third. Tell everybody at home who you are.
I am Caribban Wendigo. I am an orphan child of the arts, but turned to thief by the night. I've been to many prisons for many bad things and escaped many prisons with many bad things. I will conquer the gauntlet this evening so that I may buy a ship and sail away and live out my life in peace and harmony away from the world.
Mm. Yes, for any situation seems like peace when you have escaped the horrible walls of a prison. But perhaps peace does not await him when he is faced with the gladiators of the gauntlet. Wizard. I know a wizard when I see one, for I, a wizard myself, have met most of them. Not all of them, but most of them. I've crossed paths with you. Tell everyone at home who you are.
Yeah, wizard, also princess. Name is Beans. My dad is a king in a far, faraway land. You've probably never heard of it, but he is a big deal. Taking a gap here right now, just trying to see what's out there, see what to be seen. Heard about this gauntlet thing, thought, pff, I could do that. So I'm here now, just to strut my stuff, and I'm a wizard.
Excellent, Beans. Beans, the magical fruit, the more you use your magics, the more you find yourself successful in the halls of the Godland, yes. Now, for those of you watching at home, if you are just joining us, you must know that the Gauntlet is a dangerous game, and you can make it more dangerous, or perhaps less dangerous. Yes, that is right. You may affect the game as they go forward inside of this dungeon crawl. Now, if you donate 25 of your Earth dollars with hashtag potion, you will help these heroes. If you donate 25 of your Earth dollars with hashtag trap, you can harm them in their quest. Now, if you're feeling a little frisky, a little imaginative, a little special of the brain, then you may donate 50 of your Earth dollars for hashtag custom potion or hashtag custom trap, which will allow you to craft a potion or a trap that will forever be entered into the deck that I shall pull from whence forward. Now, if you are feeling particularly out of your mind, like some sort of person who has lost all faculty and all reason, you may get crazy, break the rules of the Gauntlet, cause madness to occur. You may donate 75 of your Earth dollars for a hashtag Uber trap, hashtag Uber potion, for something super crazy, as always named for the dangerous mage known as Uber Baldi. Now, if this team is able to succeed tonight and beat the highest score of skulls on the board, which was 228 set last week by the library bards and the last action heroes, they will be the team that joins me in my battle against the Dark Lord Krathicus Rakdok. For Rakdok marches on us every day. Yes, he comes to the southern lands of Deiros, hoping to wipe out all who walk upon two legs, for he is a Vrock that swings over the villages with his fire breath, with his very pointy sword, with his wings and his scary, scary beak. Oh, is he dangerous? Yes, he is horrible. I have faced him only in battle once, and I hope to do so with the strongest warriors of the land. Now let us see if they have what it takes to win in the Gauntlet! Yes, now, the games begin. We find our heroes in the Hall of Heroes, where they see glittering statues, crumbling walls. Now, you, it is your move.
It is my move.
What shall you do?
I'm gonna investigate first around. Let me move. These statues look shady.
That they are.
One, two, three, four. I walk up to a short-looking statue. Looks pretty aggressive.
Aha! Hawk! Our first donation of the day.
Oh my.
Goblin hashtag trap hashtag Shiawassee.
Ah, we see the mighty Trogaf, our goblin coordinator, has already thrown challenge into the ring.
Oh my gosh.
Well, yes, you approach.
I'm ready.
You approach that, but it is not entirely directed at you. Now, before things get crazy, the first trap goes to the wizard.
Oh.
Now.
Oh, guys.
Suddenly, as you all survey the land around you, full of golden statues that are made of previous heroes who failed inside of the Gauntlet, suddenly, from the sky comes forth the swift, deadly, pink, fluffy unicorns.
Oh.
Ah!
So cute.
Yet again.
Hashtag trap MUWHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAHAH
H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H-H two, Lyra. Oh. Now, one trap at a time, for I can only read one thing at a time, as you might understand, is reasonable. But the pink funky unicorns do spring forward, and you all must roll. I will roll it for you. It is a 3d8 plus 10 of damage. The pink fluffy unicorns do swoop down.
Oh,
each of
gosh.
Them, there are four of them. They all pin you. All of your against the wall.
They're not just cute. Oh my god.
How cruel. Nine.
So cute.
Nine times three.
27.
27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. 27. So 37 damage dealt.
Oh, to me? Yeah.
All of you.
Oh my God! Oh.
All of you are dealt. Curse
you, unicorns!
You are pinned against the wall.
Oh no.
Yes, these unicorns, while kind, if they were so kind, why would they have a horn? For stabbing, that is why.
Oh,
damage is dealt.
We all get 37 points of damage.
Ouch.
That's
37
insane.
Damage dealt to each.
I have to do math.
That's so much.
It is a lot. It is a lot of harm done for the gauntlet. It is not but a fairy playground where people kiss each other on the cheeks. No, it is a place of danger and death. Now.
Yes, and it's guarding his way.
Yes, it is. But now, keep in mind that 37 damage is nothing when you are facing down the hordes of Kratikus Raktok. No, as he finds you and your camp as they are sleeping, poisoning your water wells. Now, the second trap, which is dealt to Lyra. Actually, no. Ooh, I think this might actually do some superb damage.
She's
we are starting with ferocity. Evil spectators from the realm known as Earth, for I believe that this may kill everyone. Because a fiery, brutal arrow.
We just met.
You all met, but what better way to bond than through harm
and through death?
For the pink fluffy unicorn does spout forth from its mouth fiery arrows that do take the other shoulder. All of you are pinned against the walls. Now, there is a way you may stop it. There is a way indeed. Now, each of you go down the line, roll of the d20, and add your reflex score. Do you see your number reflex?
Yep.
So one by one, now go.
Yes, yes.
See if your reflex save. If you can get over 25, it will save you from an extra d6 of damage.
17.
17?
Total, yeah, 4 and 13.
Seven. I am afraid, no, it is a harm. It is an extra d6 when the time comes. Now, equip to you.
Oh, 4. Don't put it again. Oh, shit.
Roll inside the little QB.
I'm trying. I'm so nervous.
There
3.
Plus six.
I'm afraid no, and then on to you, sir.
Oh my God!
Woo!
Plus 14 plus 13 is
27.
He's saved. He's saved.
Yeah.
Tiny.
Okay.
9, 6, 9.
Plus 15. Oh wow, that's a 24.
I'm afraid it is just out of reach.
What?
Now 2 times 4, 8. Int plus 23 points of damage dealt to all except for Caravan.
I'm dead!
What the heck? I'm dead already!
And you? Also dead?
Dead? Am I dead?
How many? Was it? 24?
20.
You have one.
All of them are dead!
You have one. She's still alive.
No, she's
still alive.
Lyra hangs on by a thread.
She subtract 24.
By an elven thread.
Oh, I have one point.
Just like that, sweet life. Now keep in mind, after one, it is a round of penalty. You'll come back to life. Unless we can get a sweet subscriber to bring these fine folks back to life immediately. But if not, it has been dangerous immediately.
Who's gonna help us?
Instantly.
Help us.
The pink fluffy unicorns have dealt their damage. And two of our players, the wizard and the rogue, lay dead and bleeding on the floor. How horrible. Unicorns, so mean, so dark, so dangerous. Now, Lyra.
Yes.
It is on to you. It is on to you to attack these horrible statues.
All right.
We must prevail.
Okay, so I'm going to move towards one right now. I'm going to do that. I'm going to move a little bit closer. And I see him, and he's really gold and really strong.
So you approach Rabufa. Rabufa was once a dangerous warrior until he failed in the gauntlet and was frozen. Now, what do you do to him? Do you attack?
Oh, yes.
Aha! Aha! Hark! A helpful help.
Chat puts on sunglasses, spins around, and says, so it begins, #potion #evo.
Ah, thank you, GY Sergeant Murphy, for your help. Let us see. For there are only two living in the bunch. Mm-hmm. And the help is to you, Caravan. Mr. Caravan. Drink of the potion, and then drink it sweetly like you would of the ocean. Oh. Then you may pull of a parchment of potion.
Oh. Mm. So good. Smell it.
He drinks. Mm. He guzzles it down. It tastes like leaves taste. It goes inside of him. Now, pull up a parchment potion.
What am I doing?
Come to me, look at me, look at your master boy. Now, come and pull up a parchment potion and then tell of those in the chat and the home of, and then in the stands at large, what help you have received.
I have received a teleport. Move to anywhere in the dungeon.
Ooh. Ah, teleportation. A magic that can be unpredictable, but a magic that certainly at times most dangerous can be helpful indeed.
Yes.
Now, back to the elf. Your turn continues.
Great. So do I still do I move?
You've moved, you approached it. Now roll the d20.
Oh, now I roll. Okay, alright. One.
Ah, one. Ah, it is not a good evening. What, and then add your...
What's the record to my longsword?
12.
Yep. It's plus 12. 13.
I am afraid that you are so shaken up by the dead wizard and the dead rogue that your stab, it just kind of goes... Ah, sweet God.
Hashtag trap masks. Everywhere masks, chittering masks, everywhere, eroding your sanity.
Ah, a trap yet again.
What the heck?
A trap yet again from the Gryphon Argent. Now, my sanity is going hard, but it looks like you, Lyra, you received the trap. But keep in mind that those in the Gauntlet's audience are a bloodthirsty bunch indeed.
Yeah!
What we find is the electrifying, serious, noxious gas. Now, as you stab that statue, you think that you have done damage to it, but all you have done is poked upon a button that's on its shoulder.
Oh, no.
And then the button opens out, and suddenly...
To the great and mighty master of the gauntlet, magnificent overlord of the Southern Empire, bringer of darkness, herald of oblivion, 50 earth and dollars to do as he pleases. Hashtag hail the Lord of the Gauntlet.
Thank you, Postal Patriots, for allowing what such wonderful things to do. Now, to use that as fully as it can be, for it is a custom thing put into the powers of a wizard's hands, I do call upon the underworld, and I do summon of the spirits of those who are dead, and... And let us see, one will be resurrected. Is it going to be the wizard or is it going to be the rogue?
Oh,
let's find out. Once more. It is the wizard!
Yeah!
Springing forth from the underworld of Garanya comes the wizard. Ha! Beans, you don't think I would let you sit there gathering in the dirt, sprouting flowers out of your back, do you?
I was worried for a moment, but Beans is back!
Beans is back, baby. Yes, thank you, Postal Patriots. Kind, kind helpers. But now let us keep in mind that there is danger to be dealt indeed from the Gryphon Argent. Ah, sweet lord. Sweet lord and Malachi.
Hashtag potion, sorry about the arrow trap.
Hope
this
lovely,
helps.
Lovely, lovely. You see, they are starting to become kind because they see that even if Krathicus Raktok does show up, he'll kill all of us. That's what he'll do. The potion goes to this gentleman here.
Yes.
Now, as you drink and get ready to pull out the potion parchment, keep in mind that all of you are about to get pretty harmed. Now your points go back to full.
A full.
And I drink, yes?
You drink. Now, drink. The noxious gas does spill out into the room.
Whoa.
And you all start to... a little bit of a cough. Now, 3d8, roll of the d8. It is a 3. 3 times 3, 9, carry the 2. 15, 19, 24 damage dealt to all.
Oh.
24 damage dealt to all.
I'm dead.
Just check a lot of
Beans is going strong.
The elf is dead, but the wizard remains.
The rogue is
the
dead.
The wizard remains. The rogue is dead, but keep in mind that maybe perhaps the potion that you drank will save you.
Now,
as he falls upon his knees, coughing, gasping at his last breath, he reaches out to the elven maiden saying, I'm so sorry that I failed you.
So sorry that I failed you.
Yes. Now, Pull, here, give him a potion parchment. This one, perhaps it is of a resurrectory degree.
Invisibility. Can't be seen by enemy until attacking. Bonus d6 of damage. Doesn't save my life.
No, it does not save his life. He falls dead. And now Beans! Beans the wizard is the sole living person in the room of corpses. Yeah, Beans!
Beans!
Come on, Betty!
Beans!
All right, now, Beans, take your move.
Well, I'm gonna walk right up this guy right here, right?
As you should,
Gold guy, got a little sith type thing, and let's attack it.
Do it.
Okay.
You roll your things. Oh, not that one.
Nope, six, right?
Whatever weapon you're using.
I'd like to use a lightning bolt here.
Mm.
Lightning bolt. So I'm gonna take the d6. Yes. What?
This one. A cloud.
No wait.
A cloud gathers above the head of Beans.
Oh, got it. All right. D6 is gonna be d6 times 5. So 3 times 5 is a 15.
15. Dead.
Yes!
Your lightning bolt strikes upon the golden statue, which does melt instantly into a golden staff. Oh! Subscriber!
Dance!
Thank you, Whale Dipper, for you have dipped into the well, and not only have you subscribed to Harper RPG, a channel of crazy, silly game time fun, you have also resurrected one of the heroes of the gods who lies dead.
Yes.
Now, before we resurrect Beans, you have destroyed the statue. Roll 4 skulls, and we will put our first skulls on the board.
Bring them up.
4?
6.
6, d6.
Bring them up.
2
skulls to the board, right, Curious? Did you get that right, Curious?
Yes,
thank you.
Sorry, I was reviewing an important parchment.
Yes, of course, right, Curious has to do many different tasks in his life. Sometimes cleaning the toilets, sometimes building the toilets, sometimes reading parchments. Now, let us see what that subscriber has done to resurrect one of these three. Let us find the magical die of chance.
Please.
That's for Beans again.
Yes!
Ah, double beans.
Beans is gonna live forever!
The immortal Beans!
Nah, it is you! It is you, Back Crusher!
Yes! Fine, yeah! Beans! We got it! Let's do it! Let's handle it!
Now, Back Crusher's back, which was crushed. Now slowly, the spine aligns itself. What did you see in the underworld?
Many things, just floating spines without bodies, just going around bumping into each other.
Oh, terrifying.
It's not a good place.
Not a good sight at all.
No, not whatsoever.
How many statues are in there?
Three.
Three statues, lovely. Now, the statues can attack as well.
Right,
not if you're dead.
One of them hits. One of the statues hits.
So I'm full health, correct?
And it hits Beans.
Oh. What's the
6 damage dealt.
Right.
Ah, yes, 6 damage is dealt. Now, on to you, Back Crusher. You are back to life.
I'm back.
Move forward, take your turn, attack these things, let's put them in the ground!
Clean this room up. Let's do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's that little gimly looking dude. I'm gonna attack him. I get down on my knees. I got my daggers out.
Yes. Lugra, the dwarf lord.
Ooh, yeah!
It is a hit, a fine hit indeed. You have attacked it.
Yeah, just now. Right on my knees, and I get in the back of his legs, just right there in the ligament.
Mm. Now, as it is still a frozen golden statue, it does not feel pain, but you have hit it. Now, roll for damage. Let us see if we can destroy this creature.
All right.
Aha! Ha! More things.
A flash of skull with 10 floating eye flashes in Lord Imanchiok's mind foretelling dangers. to be faced in the future, but the vision passes, and you see a goblin scurrying across the floor of the gauntlet, handing a hashtag potion to one of the heroes. Hashtag Shiawassee.
Sure.
Woo! Potion!
Sure. Oh no. I have seen the future, and the secrets that it showed were so grim, so challenging and so horrible, but oh, a sweet little goblin, full of some kind of help for one of our heroes. Oh, thank you, mighty Trogath, the goblin coordinator, for not all goblins are bad, that is a stereotype. And not all of them are bankers either, that is also a stereotype.
Beans!
It is helpful beans!
Yes!
It is helpful beans! Drink of the dark juice.
Tastes good, beans?
Yes. Does it taste like water?
What does it taste like?
Does it taste like the sewage that you serve at dinner? No.
No. Pureed kale.
Kale. Hail, hail.
Hail,
the
kale.
Glorious kale. Pull up a potion parchment. Find what good things come to you.
Heightened senses. Pass all saves until death.
That's a good one.
Hashtag potion resurrected, but blue from head to toe.
Ah. Blue from head to toe.
I don't know what that means, Master, but I would just give them a potion.
A potion shall be dealt, indeed. Now, Gryphon Agent, we thank you for helping these struggling heroes in the Gauntlet Four. We have passed through 20 minutes and two skulls are on the board. When it goes to someone who is dead, they cannot be helped. But it goes to you now. Not all the juice goes to beans. Now, we find Back Crusher will get of the potion.
This looks delicious.
Is it? Let us find out, for sometimes the most
Yeah, helpful. I can't chug things. I don't know how you did that.
Oh, it's amazing.
This is very potion-y.
Yes.
Don't talk to them. They're dead corpses.
That's right.
I'm just kidding.
I can talk to whoever I want, especially dead corpses.
That's right, I forgot.
Finally, a conversation that doesn't have to talk over me.
Yeah, that's true, yes. We'll be the lizard is full of interdimensional speakage. Now.
Thank you, Beans.
She's turning blue.
Oh. What?
Dabba dee dabba da.
What did I drink? Now,
your skin is fully blue.
Oh my
but
god.
But luckily.
Violet, she's turning violet, Violet.
Oh no. She's turning blue and then expanding like a giant blueberry thing.
Oh no! Oh my god!
But let us see how helpful it can be. Pull up a potion parchment. Take the card, put it from the deck. Yes, more of the juice. Thank
Let's
you, Rycurious.
True strike, auto hit.
That is a great thing. I would suggest holding on to that until we reach a gladiator. Do not waste it upon these tiny little creatures. Put
it
upon your
own.
Now, Beans, what that means is that you are protected from all of these traps, potentially. If they have a save element, like where I say roll a save, I will tell you when that happens.
Oh, it passes all saves.
It passes all saves until you have died, but you have a pretty high AC, but you were just resurrected. Fantastic work. Now, did you get to do your turn?
You approached him. Did you attack?
She did. And hit. Yeah, now roll for damage. What was the damage?
Roll for damage. So bad. Two. Plus three, five.
Five. It is dead.
Yeah.
Yes. The statue of Ramboom crumbles in front of you. The damage is dealt. It is dead. Now remove it from there. Wonderful.
Let's get this little bastard
beans.
Out of here.
Beans with the memory. I like it. Now roll over d6 for skulls.
Let's do this. Get a team, come on, Beam.
Yes!
Boom. Five skulls to the right, Curious! Woo! Now you guys will both come back to life in the following turn, but now we move to Beams.
Beams! Six squares, huh?
Mm. Let's clear the room.
Four, five, yes, God! She attacks the guy in the corner, the little guy there, and she attacks! She's gonna go ahead and use a fireball! Oh, wait a minute. D6 times 5, 20-foot radius. Would that get this guy?
Yes.
That would?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Oh, wow.
Fireball.
You can finish it off.
Oh.
We are not.
Beans. 1 times 5, still a 1.
Still a 1.
Still 5.
What?
What?
Five to one.
Five.
Five. What's the dealio, Beans?
So it's five?
Yep.
I am afraid it does not hit.
Mother.
Beans.
We're never gonna get out of here.
No, you will. Don't worry. Time remains. Now, the two. How many? We have one statue remaining or two?
We have two.
Two?
Two remaining.
Two remain. Two attack. Both hit.
What?
And they hit both of you.
No, low.
You know, one times anything is zero.
Beans, you take six damage.
Why?
Take
what did
three.
I do?
You
Woo-hoo.
Got hit by the golden
Not
statues.
That bad.
F the statues. Mm.
Girl, she not doing guys, so bad. Let's do this.
Now on to you.
Okay.
Now, suddenly, rumbling, life springs back into Lyra and Caravan. The teams united once more.
Woo!
Now let us get a move, let us slay these creatures and find more foul, fell beasts in the future.
Oh,
now,
do we get
to
full
you
ba- health now?
Full health.
Oh, yeah.
Full health. To you, Back Crusher.
Back Crusher.
Back. Oh, let's do this. Let's just end these guys then.
Yes.
Let's move those over. 1, 2, 3, 4. I pull up to the same guy that dealt me damage. Oh. I'm going to end it this time.
A vengeance strike.
Yeah.
The most dangerous strike there can be.
Six.
16. 16. Ah, hit. Five.
Yeah. All right.
Yes, your stabs do crumble it partially, but now let us see. Roll for damage to see if we can take it off the board.
Roll for damage while I get my dagger. And I'm going to make him blind. 4, 7.
Dead.
Ah!
He is dead.
He is dead.
Four, you have killed it. Now,
get
remove it from there. Roll for skulls.
Roll for skulls, bring it up. Oh.
Skulls.
Oh.
Bring it up.
One skull.
A single skull to the board, right, curious?
Better than no skulls.
Seven skulls.
One closer.
Seven skulls. You have to start somewhere.
Yeah.
You have to start somewhere. Now, Lyra, fresh from the elven faraway lands of Ryaufufualeshmuf. I'm sure there's a consistency to these tones. Now, on to you, Lyra. And it appears as though there is one more thing for you to attack in the realm. A single golden statue.
Oh.
Glimmers.
Yep.
Glimmers goldenly.
He's glimmering. And I approach him because he's really pretty and gold. And 12! Plus.
A hit!
Yes.
Yes,
fine.
Yes, a
hit.
24.
24. You have stricken the thing. Now roll for damage.
D10.
Just so it's
damage.
A quick stricken.
It has a quick stricken.
A quick and stricken?
Two.
20?
Two.
Plus 9?
Yes.
11!
It is dead!
Yes!
You have slain it.
Clear the room. Teamwork.
Alright, now roll for skulls.
Oh.
1d6, and don't forget to clear the little dicey spot.
Mm-hmm.
Four skulls for the board, right, curious?
Oh.
Oh. Get rid of him.
That's yours now.
Oh, it's mine.
Now you have cleansed it. You are feeling a surge of joy, for you have all sprung back to life. You have cleaned the womb of these silly golden statues that can't really hurt you, but still are things you must slay nonetheless. And suddenly, you find a curiosity in you, and you say, you know what? I touched that fountain once, and while it did burn my hands, I have a feeling that a second shot might help. And perhaps it's true, you all approach it. You all look in as it is all so gold and glowy, and then suddenly a whirlpool doth appear, and it swirls you in, it sucks you through, and it spats you out into this room over here.
Oh!
Oh!
Woo, what a trip.
Yes, you do get blurted through. From a crack in the earth, you search around, and oh no, there are skeletal beings.
Oh,
but the skeletal beings that do start to charge you are nothing, for now our first gladiator has been awoken. You have entered the room of Tiltork!
Oh.
Tiltork, the noble orc, does enter the arena!
Damn.
Guys,
Who's that?
I don't know. Who's a bad
boy? Who shall see for two? Now, I must remind people, my orcish is orcish, so let me listen a little extra clear. Yes, that is orcish for me blood, me kill, me want, hurt others.
Oh, God.
It's a loose, yeah. Some of those words, right, depending on context, but I'm also reading his intonation.
Okay.
Yes. Now, Tiltor, keep in mind, he is not just a mindless being. He had a family of 50 children and wives. Oh, no.
Piercing the mind of Lord of Montaic, a second vision of a burning sky filled with countless eyes and death. Fading laughter fills the air and a hashtag trap materialized out of the air. Ominous. Hashtag Shiawassee.
A second vision of darkness. Of pain, of like a weird little sheep creature that's like sort of a sheep, but not quite a sheep. I don't know. I'll have to revisit the vision at one point. But it is not good. There is darkness. There is darkness, and some will befall us right now. A trap has entered the realm. Let us see who it shall hit.
No. I love you guys. No.
Caliban!
Oh. Yes!
You thought that you could hide in your pockets? No. No, Caliban, I am afraid that you cannot. For Tiltork has entered the realm, and a potion is far from you, for a trap has come forth when a vicious, horrid spike doth protrude. It is you, Caliban. I am afraid damage was dealt, as Tiltork did spring forth from the ground. Also, a spike did scroom through right through your leg, right through your thigh. Shklaw!
Shklaw!
Oh, it hurts so bad! Ow. Owie, he says.
Ouchies!
Ooh, the pain. Why do I still feel it? Why was this invented? Pain, such a terrible thing. All right, 23 damage dealt.
23!
Half my damage.
We still have you though. We still
got you. We need a band aid.
25, right?
Yeah, get like a small band aid.
The first
blood
has to skip.
I'll heal you. I'm gonna try to heal you.
Please do.
Put a band aid.
Now the pain has been harmed. But of course, wait, whose turn was it?
Feels better already.
Hey, good question.
It was Tiltork's turn. Now, the darkness that you must know in Tiltork's mind is that his family was taken from him by Narondine the Night Boy. Known as a hero to some of those of Deiros, but known as a terror to many of the creatures of the Gauntlet. For in their tiny little orc cave, when Tiltork was reading one night from a tablet with stories written in blood, he told his orc children a tale when Narondine the Night Boy did slay them all. Now, if Tiltork can survive the Gauntlet, perhaps he will be able to go to the orc underworld of Valhnerthapur to return them to Earth. But for now, he is trapped, and he battles against you. Tiltork does come forth, and he turns his angers to all of you.
Ooh. What? Let's stand together, guys. Let's do this.
11 plus 9, 20. 20. Ah, it is a miss against all of you.
Yes!
Thank the Lord. Tiltork is...
Finally!
And he swings so fast and so quick. But of course, he is so blinded with rage that sometimes he hits too spontaneously around. But... fear not, Tiltork, for your aids, these skeletal beasts, of which there appear to be about six, they do attack, and let's see if they hit. Roll of the dice of chance. And three of them hit, and the damage is dealt to Lyra. Lyra, a second time. No, I'm just kidding. And then you. Oh no. Backcrusher. And then finally, to the man. With the thing through his leg.
It hurts so bad.
It hurts. That it does. Now the damage that is dealt is...
walk it off.
Four. Three. Four.
Four?
Yes. For Tiltorx roars, do let his minions know that you must attack for him, and attack they do. They slice, they swing.
Watch out, guys.
Stab, stab. Ah, done. Now, back crusher. Move on. Will you attack the minions? Will you attack Tiltorx? Tell us.
What is a true strike? What is an auto hit?
An auto hit means that you can just do damage. I would suggest you use it against Tiltorx.
I'm gonna use this potion and just do an auto strike on him, a true strike.
Tiltorx!
Yeah, I'm right in front of his face, close up. I am not scared of him. He'll get missed before he can miss again.
All right. Let's do it. 16
plus 10, 26.
26 damage dealt. Ah, yes, a fine strike. Tell us, what does it do to the creature?
Let's see. I stab his arm, his shoulder. His arm, he cannot use that arm. Just his arm with his biggest weapon in there.
In the blood.
Everywhere. He gets all over on the ground. He slips around. It's not good. He's just confused. He's not balanced.
All right, let's see.
He's not dead.
Not dead? Okay, not yet.
All right,
not yet.
Okay. Move along. Your sword has wedged right into his like little socket, and it's popped it out. Like he was one of your Earth action figures that you were just tiny little destructive children plucking their limbs off.
He does a pop and lock, though, too. He starts dancing. It's very confusing. Like, it doesn't make sense. No. You want a fighter dance.
Yes, Tiltorx feels the pain, and seeing the blood gushing from his orc arm, he does use his orc tears to cry into the wound, which is made of toxic poisons, and it seals the wound, and he springs back onto his feet, ready to do more damage. But Lyra swiftly approaches. Yes. You attack the minions, you attack Tiltorx. Aha! More things.
The wizard's fireball, instead of auto-hitting the golden statues, has apparently turned into a hashtag potion.
Aha!
Potion!
It is for you now. It looks like Beans is being given some more friendly fun time. Drink more of the sweet juice that is fine with Hella. Stones upon you.
You didn't want the exact
kale,
like a darker kale.
Chug it.
Oh, you finished it. Oh, yeah.
Almost all of it.
That was the best.
It was a good one.
Chug your gun.
Play the
excellent
flute.
Beans.
Potion!
Potion parchment. Pull you of the card. Tell us of the truth.
Cure serious wounds! Plus D, 3d8 plus 15. HP restored. What does that say?
Plus two, move the dread dog.
Oh, fantastic. And what's the bottom? Okay, move your fingers.
That's what we don't know.
We can figure
plus
that out.
Plus two per two. It helps you. Hang on to it.
It's a good thing.
Are you hurt right now?
Yes.
Well, how hurt are you?
I have 11.
Oh, you're pretty hurt. Yes. I would say use it now.
Use it now.
Yes. Now, roll
a
3d8. Yeah, so then add that to your thing. Ah, thank you, Beetel Tirik. Beetel Tirik has helped the wizard Beans. A powerful ally for this team.
3d8?
Yeah. 3d8.
Well, the 8, right?
Yeah. So roll that and then times it by 3. Or you can roll again by 3. You can roll it 3 times or times it. So just roll it twice more. So 1, 3, or 1, 4, so 5. You roll once more. 5, 6 plus 15.
15.
6 plus 15. So you have 21 points you can add to your health points. Ah, kind spectators
have turned their toad
indeed. First, delivering damage, now delivering help. But we move to Lyra.
Lyra!
Oh! I move 6 spaces.
Yes.
I'm going to go up to the skeleton. Because he's just really annoying.
Yes!
Just
what are you, Kate Moss?
We need to take the fucking gladiator down, guys. We need to fuck.
We're good.
Sorry, I was lost in the vision. I had a vision hangover. Now, you approach the creature. Attack.
Attack! Oh, so this one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 4.
16 is a hit, fine hit.
All right.
Yes.
Yes, you knock it upon its bottom.
And it's, yes, there's bones crunching everywhere. It's really disgusting, but I love it. Okay, and is that a six or a nine?
Six.
Plus nine is 15.
Ah, you have killed the skeletal beast.
Ah, yes.
Nice, now roll for skulls.
Oh, skulls.
And remove it from the arena.
Oh, yes. Goodbye.
One's gold to the board, right, Gary?
You're welcome.
Skimpy.
It's fine, you're taking them off the board, making it safer for yourselves and your allies. We now move to Caraban.
Yes.
Freshly back onto the battle.
Yeah.
Oh, it feels
Damn
good to be
skulls.
Back. One, two. I moved to strike this little skeleton dog pig creature.
He's cute.
You get distracted because it sounds like Beans is also making the sound.
Multiple beings.
Rough. Now,
oh, right.
Move forward.
Move forward. And I ignore the one, the big one.
Let's do it.
Oh, girl.
Nice.
10 Woo! Plus 10 is a 20.
20!
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm impressed. Since you know, the spike in your hand is not.
Oh, so I will move to stab the creature in the head with one of my daggers. And I rolled a 2 plus 3 is 5.
5, it is death of this creature. What do you do to this dog?
I crush its skull between my hand and the dagger, and I move to smash its all brains within the dagger and crush with my hand until it falls to pieces.
Dust and death. The thing is dead. Remove it from the arena and roll yourself a
Get
skull.
Get them skulls!
Do this!
Five skulls! Yes. Lovely, lovely. Now, on to Beans.
Beans.
I want to stay where I am because I got two guys to attack right there.
Great.
Okay. And so they're in front of me, and so I'm gonna use a lightning bolt. My last lightning bolt. So what I need is this guy, right? Six? That's good. All right, so this is gonna be this times five. Or I can roll it five times. Roll it five times?
Times about
five. Oh, girl! Because guess what? That's 6 times 5, which is 30.
Ooh, okay. It is dead. You have slain the thing. Right
two of them, though, look! Because it goes like that.
Because it goes like that?
Yeah! Yes. It goes
in calm. It sounds pretty confident.
Double kill.
Can I kill him, though?
Double kill. Roll again. I'll let you roll it a second time.
Oh, I see.
Go.
One gets the
one gets the royal smackdown.
Five.
Yes,
five.
You have 25.
Slay them all.
Yes.
Three. So okay, with the lightning bolt. Lightning bolt. Wait. Yeah. Okay, it goes through one, and then that body flies in the other one, and then knocks it out, and then that kills the second one.
Lovely. Yeah. Dead. Double. Deadness. Four wizards have magic so slippery and powerful.
Skull?
Roll for them. Roll for the skulls. The curse. The curse of a single skull. The second skull. 6, 7 skulls to the board! Whoa! Icarus!
Run out of lightning bolts.
Oh no, wait. What's now, going on?
Tiltalk. Now it is Tiltalk's time to strike.
Oh no.
Now Shit. He leaps back onto his feet. Roaring and raging against all of you, he turns his sights with one arm down, but one arm angrier than it has ever been. He swings, and it is a six blub. It is a miss.
Yeah!
It is a miss. But of the remaining skeletons also do leap into the fray of battle to turn their sights to the creatures around them. One is a hit, and the hit goes to you, Backcrusher.
Damn
yes,
it.
And the back crusher is harmed.
Oh god.
And the amount of harm that is dealt, 6 points of damage dealt. But it goes right for the back of the back crusher. It leaps upon and starts Holy stabbing god. Upon your spine like this.
Jesus! Help! Oh shit.
Oh my goodness, how dangerous a thing. How did we get into this situation? Because we live in a fantasy world where everybody fights everyone. Onto you, Backcrusher.
Onto
you.
Oh my god.
Go, Backcrusher! You got
my neck, my neck.
Keep in mind
that
Till
is
talking.
I'm gonna do it, guys.
Take him out.
Someone must kill Till.
Someone, since everyone else is just fucking around with
Sorry.
I'm lazy.
I was in a corner.
We were dead.
You're doing lovely. You're wonderfully, wonderfully, everyone.
That's a 16.
It is a miss. You swing and Tiltork just.
Oh, God.
Ding! He knocks it to the floor.
Oh, my God.
And he gives an orc roar.
What is he?
That sounds
he's lovely. Saying,
what is he saying?
He's saying, not today, is what he said. Now, the elf.
I'm going to go. I want to use my bow and arrow because I'm a little bit far away.
Wonderful, but I think you can also remove your spaces.
Oh, I can move spaces.
And keep in mind that flanking is a helpful thing.
What does that mean?
So it means you can sandwich them. It's like a Knight at the Roxbury type move.
Let's do that.
So I go to that side.
What was
the thing we did? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yes, onto the other side. Lovely. Flanking. Now that is a +2
flank
to hit.
Flank you. What?
Flank you.
Flank you.
Tiltork, seeing that you are surrounded by the two. Now.
Now I roll. Move.
Yes.
All right. 16 +12.
Hit. Hit!
Yes,
a
hit.
Yes.
So your bow and arrow, you launch the arrow. What does it do?
Oh, I decided to do the long sword instead.
Oh, you did? Okay,
I decided to go with the sword. I was a bit
Use
closer
the sword.
Now.
Use the sword.
I went right into his intestines. And then I ripped it out. And, you know, his guts, just were spilling everywhere. It was disgusting, really.
It was a mess.
Yeah, it was a mess. Gross.
Great, now roll for damage.
Okay, great. this one?
Yep.
Nineteen
damage dealt. Yes, for a moment sputtering like a hose that nobody was controlling on the front lawn, his intestines start spilling juice this way and that, and it splatters you all, but it does no damage. And you can tell that you're doing damage, and it gives you a little bit of bloodlust, and he's just... Which means, oh no, not my intestine! And then he uses his orc tears again to. And they drip and they heal his wounds. That's an orc skill. Everybody knows that orcs can cure their own wounds with their magical toxic tears. What are you, some kind of commoner who doesn't know such a thing? Now, it has been dealt. What was the number?
19?
19 damage dealt. Tiltork still stands, still roars, but is slowly being taken down by these champions who have found their stride of violence inside of the gauntlet. On to you, Caravan.
All right. I'm going to move towards Tiltork. 3, 4, 5, 6. Close enough to do a dagger throw?
Yes.
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 I'd like to throw my daggers at Tiltork. No!
Oh, crap.
That's the one. 11. Yes, you throw the you throw the dagger, but Tiltork, he catches it in his teeth like this.
Of course he does.
And then he chews it.
No, my dagger.
He turns it back on
the dagger.
And then he crumbles it in his mouth and he swishes it around like mouthwash. But then rather than spitting it out, he swallows it.
Aww.
And then it kind of turns on him. He's like,
ooh. I should make that day.
You speak Orcish? I should be letting this guy translate, my lord.
Yeah.
Now, Beans.
Beans!
Do your damage.
There it is.
Beans.
Six.
Who every time remembers that she is Beans, says, Beans!
You are, woo! All right. Flanking the monster.
What's his name, Tiltork?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's see, what do I get? I'm right ahead of him. Oh, but I can hit, I don't hit any foes here. I mean, friends, I mean. Wait. Oh, wait.
You have the cone.
Yeah. Would that hit you guys too, though?
Yes.
Is it worth it? Is it
cone.
Worth it?
Is it
Just
worth
take
that?
It.
Let me work.
They're good.
I'm
my
glass.
It's worth it. It's worth it.
All right. So I'm going to use my cone. My burning hands. So D4 times 5.
I don't know how to read this.
15. The one at the bottom. 15 damage. 15. Right. You burn it. What are you, burning hands is what you use?
Burning hands.
What does your burning hands do to this horrid beast?
Well, from afar, burning hands appear in the back of its head and shake it, tremble it, until its head becomes loose and wobbly like a tooth.
Yes, it has happened. You have. It does not kill him.
Yeah.
But you have harmed it, and now he does have a floppy head.
Yes.
Like a loose tooth in a
mouth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Keep in mind that while his tooth is loose, his orc arm is strong.
Oh my god.
Oh no, is he coming for us?
Oh,
coming.
He is indeed. He turns, and now his head can't see as well, so he uses his tornado move, which you might know. He spins around like a Tasmanian devil from the Earth cartoons. 17. Plus 9 is 26. All are hit by Tiltork. All are hit by Tiltork. He uses his spinny move, and then to cap it off, uses his orc screech, which is like this. So not only does it harm you physically, it also makes you go, ow, so loud, I don't like it. No.
So bad.
Yes, I know, isn't it terrible?
Right.
Such a terrible thing. And the damage that is dealt is 10 plus 1, Jesus. 20 damage dealt.
To everyone? Jesus.
Yes, Tiltork, a violent creature.
I'm hanging
indeed.
On by a thread.
How many remaining skeletal beasts? I believe that was just a single one.
There's some sort of giant hand. Severed hand.
There's a hand.
Where?
Definitely a hand.
Yeah.
Where's this giant severed
giant
hand?
Giant severed hand.
It's right here.
A giant severed hand. Yes, that once belonged to a giant creature known as and Moop was very tall. And not actually all green. Each different limb was a different color. But his green hand was the strongest.
Fancy, I like that.
Well, that's
that's very nice.
Yes, we all like it. Like but you will not like it when the hand of Moop does strangle you to death.
No!
Oh! Everything's going crazy.
Was
I lost
a
die.
We have a rogue dice.
He was a fantastic. He had a green thumb. He was good at something else too. All right.
Lots of green.
Yeah.
So much green.
He was the guy.
Both of the attacks hit. Both of the skeletal beast and of the hand of Moop.
Nope.
The hand of Moop does leap onto the neck of Beans.
Beans.
Not Beans.
Watch out.
Beans.
And it strangles Beans of 3 points of damage. And then, of course, the other darkness does be dealt to you, Caravan.
No.
6 points of damage.
I'm dead
dealt.
Again.
No.
No. Hello, Caravan has come. For Beans, for Beans tried to save Caravan.
He's cheating on me.
But couldn't quite do it because the hand of Moop.
Oh my god. No.
The hand of Moop did push the wizard against the wall.
There's not that door for both of us.
He has died. Is there not but a watcher who wants to become a subscriber who could resurrect this poor one from the underworld?
Please.
Bring him back into the realm of the living.
It's like a prison.
We love him so much.
Prison down here.
Yes,
we both love him that he's mine.
He's mine, actually. No, he's mine. That's wrong.
Boy is mine.
No.
All right, on to you.
Oh, dude, I'm gonna attack Tiltork.
Tiltork.
Get it, Tiltork. It's over.
Tiltork.
Yes. Get his other arm
yes,
and get up with my dagger.
The hand of Moop.
Are you dead?
But I speak from beyond.
13.
I am afraid it is a miss.
Oh, jeez, guys. Sorry. Yes.
It is a swing. Swing and a miss. On to you now, Lyra.
All right. I'm going to try to hurt the orc again.
Exactly. With your long sword.
Yes, long sword. Oh,
2 plus 12,
14.
14 plus 2, it is a miss again.
It is a miss.
The team is struggling. And then, of course, we have the dead corpse.
Yes.
Who is it? No
doubt.
Oh.
Please!
Help.
Hashtag custom potion, a potion marked by a label that reads, that damn stubbornness. Containing the essence of ancient heroes, the next damaging attack or effect that would kill the consumer is negated, leaving them with 1 health.
Oh, okay. So instead of killing us, it leaves us with 1.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
So it's
awesome.
Yes, she's very bad.
I'll gap you.
Beans.
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 So the
good
one.
For lots of things.
Now you shall see. We shall see who gets such a thing.
Beans.
Can a dead man drink, you think? No. Oh, subscriber, he's back!
Woo! Subscriber.
Hyper RPG,
thank you.
A channel of games and fun and friends. Now, if you are just joining us, we've entered the gauntlet.
You're back,
a gladiatorial battle that uses Pathfinder as a dungeon crawl. Now, just to join us, we have resurrected a champion in the realm.
I miss you so much. We love you very much.
Back to life. Now, that potion goes to you.
Oh, I get to drink a potion.
Right. Drink him a potion, and now the next time you are on death's doorstep, you shall remain alive and receive a single point.
Oh, great! Alright, I'm so excited.
It's like having an extra life, but not really.
Yes.
Lovely.
Alright, moving along. Moving along. You went. You're back to life now.
Lyra.
Beans just.
You're
back to life.
I'm back
so
to life.
Your
yes.
Yes.
If you're back, it's you.
I'm going?
Yeah, you just went, right?
I just drank a potion.
The potion went to Lyra. Lyra got the potion.
And it's
thank you,
turn.
I feel great.
Roll! Right.
That was good. I lost 3 pounds. Look at me, you're enemy.
Oh, I want that potion.
You know what?
I'll drink many of them.
I know, but sometimes it's, muscle.
I'm going to move to strike this skeleton creature behind my partner's back because I need to have my other rogue's back. It's very important so that she doesn't get stabbed.
That is true indeed.
That's really nice. So I'm gonna
caravan springing back to life, wasting no moment.
14 plus 10 is 24.
Strike!
Nice!
I take my daggers out and I shove them right up inside of his chest and I move to strike him. Five plus three.
It's dead.
It is dead. You have killed it.
Yes.
Yay! Yeah!
So I gem at the daggers, gem them up inside, and I lift him up and I throw him against the wall.
Oh, it's so strong.
And as you do so, once it hits the wall, it just explodes into a bunch of bones, and they all crumble into a perfect pile. And then a tiny dog that was in the hallway runs in and urinates on it. You have killed the creature. Now roll for skulls. Six skulls to the board. Fantastic, they are on track. He has been removed and is dead. Now we turn to the wizard. I would suggest turning off ice for Tiltork.
We're gonna Tiltork. Let's see. I can go straight in front of me. Let's see, I got that cone again. Should I do that? Yeah, I'm gonna Burning Hands it.
Ah, well, a fine choice, wizard.
D4 times 5.
Mm-hmm.
Not bad. 3, so I got a 15.
15 damage done. What does it do to the beast?
Oh, well, it takes the loose head and twirls it around. And it stretches it like taffy.
Yes. And then Tiltor's head does fall off and is dangling like taffy, and he's holding on only by his tongue.
Ooh,
his tongue connects his head now. The head is bouncing back and forth with a sort of cord that's his own tongue that goes back into his head. And the tongue goes to about here.
Yeah.
You didn't know that the tongue is about this long.
Deep.
Now Tiltor is furious at such a thing. And he turns his battle again to all of the champions.
I'm not
gonna miss. He's gonna miss again, guys.
10 plus 9. He does miss.
Yes!
He's not really good.
Yes, his orc attack does not strike. But of course, we now still have the Hand of Moop. The hand of
Moop. Oh, Jesus. I got all about Moop.
I hate the Moop.
The hand of Moop.
Shout for the hand.
While it pushed the wizard against the wall, it has not turned its sights to beans this time, no. And by sights, I mean its hand sights. It turns its hand sights to Lyra. And it is
do?
A strike, and the strike goes. It's just a single strike, just one hit.
Okay.
So it just sort of grabs you and then tries to push you against the wall, but you slip out of it.
Yes.
And then it's like this.
Very sneaky. I'm so sneaky.
Yes. The hand of Moop moves on now.
Bye, Moop. You.
Back Crusher. Back Keep the battle crusher. Alive.
I'm gonna attack the orc again. Jesus, this is gonna end this. I'm getting my daggers and I'm gonna get his tongue ripped off.
Yum.
Yeah.
Yes.
Freaking 12.
12 is a miss. You go for the tongue, but the tongue is so slippery and gross that you're like, yuck. And you don't want to touch it anymore. And, and your momentary skittishness does allow Tiltorc to survive this round. On to you, Lyra.
Oh, okay. All right, I'm going to attack. I'm going to attack. Let's see. 12.
Plus, are you using longsword?
Yes, longsword. 12 plus 12, 24.
24. It is a hit.
Yes. It's a hit! Yes!
A hit, a fine
D2.
Hit. Now roll for damage.
Great, okay.
Six plus nine.
15
damage dealt.
Is he dead?
He's not. What does it do? He is harmed.
Tell him.
Damn points.
What does it do to him?
Attack him.
Oh, well, I went for his kneecap and I like bashed it in a bit.
Ow.
And his bone sort of started sticking out. And you know, I kind of just like ripped it a little bit and then I cracked it and then I pushed him over.
Ah, wonderful. And he says, ah, all of that orc gold I spent on knee surgery out the window. And he then is crying and sad. On to you now, sir.
Aww, sorry, not sorry.
So yeah, I know. I feel like a little bad, but not really.
Not so bad.
One, two,
three.
Getting him.
Move to flank on Tiltorc with the rest of my team. And I move to strike with my daggers. 3. Plus 10, 13.
13 is a miss.
Yes. I mucked it up.
It's all right.
It's all right.
You were counting on there being a neck there, but instead his taffy-like neck bouncing around causes you to miss the neck and the tongue, for the tongue is so slippery. Yes. Wizard.
And deep.
I think I got one burning hands left. Gotta do it.
D4.
What? Wait, times, what are we doing? 5, okay. 4 times 5 is 20.
20, ah, a fine hit indeed. He still stands, but damage is
Are you kidding me? This guy!
He's a lot.
Yeah,
he's
a lot. The gladiators are hard to slay, but yes. you are pushing him towards death. Like, tell us, what does it do?
Yeah, it is just, it's like a breath of stinky air that follows him around permanently now, making his own existence torture, so even he wants to be slain!
He's saying, is that me? And he doesn't know if it's him. So partially the damage is the smell itself and the fear of wondering if it is his own stench.
Yes.
Now as his head bobbles around like a tether ball in a children's playground.
He's gonna miss again.
And it is 19, he does miss.
Yeah!
Thank you.
But do not forget that the hand of Moop still stands.
Moop is like cousin it. He just won't go away.
Now, Moop turns to you, Beans.
What?
Beans!
And he takes Moop and he throws you into the little water areas you see. And he shoves your head into.
Beans!
5 damage is dealt.
She's fine.
Good.
She's fine.
Come now, children. Fight this creature. I believe you can kill him in this round.
I will kill him in this round. I'm gonna get his arm, his final arm.
We need.
Let's do this.
25.
Get my daggers out, both of them this time.
Please.
7.
17.
Miss.
Jeez.
Big numbers.
All right.
Kill gladiators.
Right.
And other things.
Eight.
Plus?
No.
12.
20.
Miss.
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 Really
daggers.
Get the
roadblock.
13 plus 10, 23.
23, it is a hit.
Boom! Yeah. Right. So I'm gonna take my daggers and I'm going to do the Drax stab where I stab him in the abdomen
many times.
Six plus three is nine.
9 points of
damage. And I'm flanking, right?
Do you have an addition?
I do on flanking. I have plus 10.
Fantastic. That's 19.
19.
Yay.
19.
Stabbing him all the
while. Incredibly close, but not quite. Oh! You have been saved for the wizard.
Here's my question. I can't use a spell because I'll hurt my friends right now if I do.
Is it worth it, though? Is it worth it? Let me work it.
Yeah.
Is it worth it? The spell is on the board.
So I think the only spell I have is a fireball.
Let's end this.
Which is 20-foot radius. So I would get everybody.
From the pool.
I have faith in you, B.
Let's just do it.
Yes, your team is encouraging you to do it. They will take D6. The burn themselves. They want to see this creature sent to his family in the orc underworld.
Okay, so 4 times 5 is 20.
Tiltork is dead!
And they celebrate in happiness, but at the same time, as they go to high-five beans, they also take the battle poison pains that comes from that. Tell us of the death. How do you finally send Tiltork to his floppy grave?
A fireball shoots forth, it is green, and it goes in his mouth, through his tongue, like a bloop, like through a fairy, and then it goes into his body, and then causes it to expand, and then it shrinks into nothing and just disappears without a sound.
So sad. But he is dead!
Yeah.
Yeah. No!
Skulls, 3d20. 3d20. Now this is where you can get some true skulls on this board.
Please.
Yes.
19.
Lovely! Wow, ooh. Again.
Three.
Fine.
11.
19, 3, 11.
No, because 19 plus 3 is 22 plus 11 is 33.
33! All right, things are happening. Now, keep in mind that one creature remains in the realm. And
it
is moved.
It's moved. It's
moved.
It's moved.
It's moved. It's moved. It's moved.
It's moved. It's moved. You've all gotten, you've subtracted your 20 points of damage from the fireball.
No.
Subtract.
On it.
But it was worth it. I'm gone, guys.
But now, happy that he has survived longer than Tiltork Moop does do his final damage to Caravan.
Lose again!
3 points of damage are done. Where's Moop? And then just, he tickles you.
Can't keep his hands off me. Stop it.
No.
Three.
Angered at such a thing, you turn your sights to Moop.
I am dead.
Oh, you're dead?
I'm gone. That 20, I'm gone.
I did not hear that. Guys.
Oh.
Two dead. Are you dead?
Guys, no. Back Crusher is dead.
Virus.
Oh, you're fine.
It was worth it, though. Beans had to do it.
Beans did. Now on.
You're so brave.
On to you, Elf.
Yes. Yes.
Can you finally slay Moop?
I can slay Moop. 20 plus 12 is 30.
Yeah, the natural 20 is a very good hit. Roll again to see if we get critical. Just roll the d20 again. Let's play that.
17.
Subscriber.
Lovely Eli McHugh. Thank you. Oh, no, it was Matorks 1371. Wonderful work. Now, Bean, seeing this dead friend that she has made, uses her wizard's magics to resurrect her.
Yeah!
Come back to life, Bone
Taker!
Wizards and jelly beans and beans and beans!
Pinto and Garbanzo, be my friend!
Ah!
It works!
Yes!
Back to life!
Big Bean, you're the best!
Excellent resurrection spell, Beans. Mind if I borrow that?
Put it in your pocket.
Garbanzo, really?
Garbanzo.
We'll put that in my
All Garbanzo. You need are Beans.
On to you. You have killed, now roll for damage.
Wasn't that the damage? That was the damage.
That was double this year, we got critical.
I got, yes.
And it double got critical.
So now
indeed,
I do.
Beans.
Now I do this one?
Clever.
This, yes.
Clever yes. You are, Beans.
Clever girl.
Oh. Another!
Woo! Subscriber.
We're gonna dance. Bwangri.
Woo!
Bwangri, never angry.
Never.
Welcome to Hyper RPG, for we thank thee. You have subscribed to the channel, and we have one auto resurrection on the board for when the next of you death's doorstep. But now,
Beans,
you have slain Moop. You have slain Moop. Tell us, how do you kill this thing once and for all?
That's all.
With my sword, and I...
Another!
Subscriber.
Wonderful, thank you. Was that Bwangri's thing? Was there another one post Bwangri, Ryra Curie, Stussy? For my magical mirror of tales.
It was Bwangri, and before that it was Ellie the Cube, and before that it was Mutterworks.
Mutterworks 3017, Eli McHugh and Bwangri, thank you, awesome, wonderful. And now he is dead, you have slain the creature, now roll for skulls.
Thanks!
Four skulls!
Yes, you are so happy that you all hold hands and spin in a circle.
Oh, yay!
And in your spin in a circle moment, as you hold hands and spin in a circle, Beans doth use her magical spell to say, we are covered in orc blood, we need to go somewhere warm. But in that, chosen by herself, you get sent to this lava land so far away.
Beans!
Beans! All of you go.
All of us are going to Beans!
Follow Beans!
Lava land. Now you come up for air, but the air is thick and icky and and gross. And then suddenly, springing forth from the bubbling lava, comes an old foe.
Oh no!
An old foe who is extra angry, and it is indeed.
Oh no!
It is he known as Blaze.
Whoa.
Is this Blaze?
No, Blaze is still coming.
It's not Blaze.
Blaze.
And at first, you guys, there was all this build-up, and you were scared because of the bubbling lava, and then it was this tiny little guy, and you all go, ooh,
don't touch it!
Ah, you think it's funny, huh? You think it's funny now? No. Well, you've entered into Lava Land, where only Blaze can respond to such heat.
Now keep in mind, he is extra fierce and angry, for his best friend Buddy has been trapped in a time vortex. Isn't that right, Rycurious? Or some sort of temporal rift?
I'm sorry, Master, I thought we had resolved.
The necromancers are on us. What do we pay these necromancers for? Do we pay the necromancers? I don't think we do.
We mostly just give them bodies.
We give them bodies to resurrect, and for a necromancer, that's as good as gold. What are they doing with their time? Buddy is still trapped inside of a temporal loop, but Blaze is angry, and he has come to fight. Now,
we find ourselves in the situation where Caraban, the first to be like, ooh, I should hurt that, he steps forward.
Attack.
Do you go towards Blaze, or do you attack any of the creatures surrounding?
I'm going to move to attack the other creatures since I'm closer to them and can take them by surprise because I am as silent as the phoenix.
Ah. Oh. Not known for their silence, are they?
No, they're not, but I'm as silent as well.
Now to give a quick message to all those watching in the gauntlet, yes, Nitus Phatom, the buddy system has failed Blaze indeed, and if we reach our goal tonight, we will be able to summon Buddy, summon him from the temporal rift. It will be a tip in the form of bodies that will allow the necromancers to get off of their asses and bring him forth. But for now, we fight what we can.
Which is these creatures, these lava creatures, this looking, it's like an ant.
Wasp.
It's an ant wasp mixed with like a bad attitude.
Yes, of course. Yeah. It is Thautu.
Ah, Thautu.
You approach Thautu and his I approach Thautu.
I rolled a 4, I've got 10, I've got 14.
14, it is a miss.
Damn it.
He slips out. The heat is starting to tug you down. But of course, Beans was seeking heat, which is why you ended up in such a hot situation in a dirt.
Do it, Beans.
Okay, girl. I got one fireball left, and I'm gonna use it right there.
On which?
Dragon Man.
Ah, Dragon Man.
The Dragon Serpent.
Dragon Man.
Lava Serpent Dragon.
This is my medallion.
Dragon Man, known as Zaru.
Dragon Gondolier.
All right, so you turn your sight to Zaru, Dragon Gondolier. So like,
okay, so one D6.
Who does stroll. He's like a gondolier, and he sings. He goes, and then he burps fire. I am Buddy here.
It's a lot of fire.
Six times five.
Six
times
five.
Ooh. 35. Right?
Dead.
Nope.
Dead.
Woo! I killed it.
Yes, you killed it.
And we're nowhere near, so it doesn't hurt us.
What a beautiful voice. Yeah, I only had to go.
Bye.
You use your fire and it melts it deeper into the lava. Roll for skulls.
Three skulls
to the board! Three skulls to the board. Lovely, wonderful. Now.
Beezy's done.
Everybody thinks that they can come in here and just knock on my door and expect to get a prize. Well, let me tell you, friends, you're not my friend at all.
Now, Blaze decides to attack. Nine plus nine, 18. It's a miss. A miss of all of you. However, many other beasts remain in the realm.
So many beasts.
Two of them hit.
Damn it.
Two of them hit. The first hits upon Caraban, pulling him down to the lava. The second hits upon Beans.
Yes!
How many?
Yes, you want to die, so you can get all your.
I need my spells
six?
Back.
Six damage dealt to the beans.
Bye!
Dead?
Yeah.
Aww. Beans is dead!
Beans!
Yes!
Bye,
beans is dead. Two to you, sir.
Two to you.
Beans is dead. Beans is back.
Beans is back!
Woo!
The beans has bounced back.
Beans was so quick to resurrect. That it was like this. It was like you fainted for a minute, then we're like, "Whoa!
What am I? How long was I out?"
Beans, you know.
Princess.
What did you see in the faint world?
Nothing.
Yes, pretty boring. Beans was dead for a moment for us, but 3,000 years of just darkness. It was a nice nap. You feel refreshed?
I feel great. Ooh. Feel great, look great, am great.
Lovely. All right, now on to Back Crusher.
Will back, crush crusher. The
back? Back Crusher.
Just like last time. I'm gonna go for the main kill. I'm gonna Blaze. Definitely go to Blaze.
All right, let's come now.
Get my daggers out. Let's do this.
Oh.
Mother!
Oh.
11.
The daggers, you threw that and Blaze grabs each one and melts the dagger.
Oh. What the heck?
Now they are just handles.
Let's.
Now you just have two handles. You're gonna have to kill with two handles. Oh. Lyra.
My turn. I'm going to go for Blaze.
Blaze. Are you going to move yourself?
Which one are you?
Oh, wait, I have to move. Where is he?
He's the little guy, yes.
He's a little gremlin looking. Yes.
He's a little... what is his species?
Master, he's a fire elemental.
He is a fire elemental.
He's horse. Oh, darn it. 16! Plus 12. Is 28.
It's a hit!
Yes!
Yes!
Yes! Don't worry, buddy. I'll find you, pal. I'll find you once I drink the blood of these silly ones here now. Quick, attack him. Roll for damage.
Go.
Four. Plus nine
is 13.
13 damage. What does it do? Aha!
In another realm, Backcrusher has a habit of losing. Backcrusher, can you win here? Roll a d20. If it is even 1, 1, 3, you die. If odd 1 to 13, a teammate dies.
Oh, wow.
Roll a 14 and auto kill on next attack.
Wow.
Roll a 15 to 18, find a trap. Roll a 19 or 20, find a potion. # uber trap.
Ubavaldi has spoken. Quick, roll before these rules slip away.
Get over 14.
Oh,
even number, that means one of us died.
You are dead.
Oh my god!
She's dead.
Screw you!
That crush is dead.
We're trapped!
You just.
Aha! But ha! More things. More magic.
Hark!
A small crack in reality appears, and from it a # potion floats towards the heroes.
Ah, a potion has come to
potion floats.
Now, you've swung your attack. But instantly, as your daggers did burn, Blaze did allow his fire elemental heat to seep into your blades, and it burned so much that the poison and the anger and the sadness that Blaze feels from Buddy being gone from him for so long, ever since he has moved down to the southern realms, because they used to fight together hand in hand in the northern realms. You know what I'm talking about there. And now it has seeped into your skin, and suddenly you melt, and you crumble, and you turn into like a lava creature, and then you walk like this, and then you slowly bubble up, pow, dead.
Oh.
But the wizard, we have resurrections.
Oh,
you
yes,
use
we do.
Your magics.
Go
no,
for it, Beans.
We have subscriber resurrections.
Oh,
another resurrection spell.
Pinto! Black Eyed P! Beans!
Woo!
Uber-balding, yeah!
Beans, the strength has come alive. Now, keep in mind that we have a potion to deal from Drift Ice Blood. Roll of the Dice of Destiny, and it goes into the face of you.
The kale? Which one?
The
kale?
Or the carrot? Carrots or kale?
Carrots is very good.
I'll do the kale.
Go
I think
kale.
It's the spinach
I did
it.
Yeah, I did the kale.
Drink some arugula.
Drink, delightfully
some
drink.
Cilantro.
What kind of potion? It's good, don't you think?
Chug.
I like it. Changed your voice.
It's a potion.
Right.
It's a silly potion.
It's a helium potion.
Though you have died, and now you are back upon potion finish, pull card from the stack. Pull up the stack and find of the truth.
Yeah.
Only then shall you have the potion juice. Pull. Tell us.
Rainbow shield, reflect one elemental attack back at enemy.
Yes. Oh, lovely.
Yes.
That is, if Blaze attacks you upon the next round, it shall turn against him. What was that? Nothing, Blaze. You're fine.
Yes.
You know what you're doing. What? You just. You're doing just fine. Don't you worry. All right. Lovely.
Whose
turn is it? We were fighting. Lyra was fighting,
I was
right?
Fighting, and then I think we had to dance.
Oh, lovely. All right. So, Lyra, take your attack again.
Yes.
I don't remember.
That's all right.
I hit it. I hit it.
You did.
You hit it. Yes, you hit it.
And I hit it. It was an attack. And I really like going for the kneecaps. So I did that again.
Oh, it was the knee thing.
Yeah, I'm really into the knee.
All right, now roll for damage. Roll for damage.
Okay.
Good.
This one.
Yes.
Nothing.
That's 10.
That's
snake
10.
Ass.
Plus 9.
Is it?
That means 10.
10 plus 9. Yes.
10
plus 19.
There we go.
Better than it was.
Yes, that's right.
just, ah, banana boat 333. I don't know what that is. Mm. It's 40, what'd you get?
19.
Fantastic. For when the master of the gauntlet forgets things, we just do them again. Right, right, Yuri? Lovely. Everybody's very nice. All right, wonderful. 19 damage dealt to Blaze, the creature. Correct.
Blaze.
All right, now tell us, what does it do? It hits his knees.
And kneecaps, again, cracking, some bone poking, and then I like pulled some of the bones out, and I just don't want him to really walk.
Wonderful. Well, you can get him onto his feet. He can, don't forget, get into the lava itself, and then you make himself like a wave person. Yes, that's a thing. Yep. There is such a thing as a lava wave person, but now we move to you, Caravan.
All right, I'm going to use my invisibility potion, where I can't be seen by enemies until attacking, and I get bonus d6 of damage. I can do that, yes?
Say it again.
Invisibility means I can't be seen by enemies until attacking.
Great.
And I get bonus d6 of damage.
Fantastic.
So I'm using it, I drink it, I'm putting it inside of my body.
So you can use that. The
and I'm going to move. I'm actually going to stay and I'm going to re-attack. I can't remember his name, but he's this wasp ant attitude guy. But I'm going to stab him.
His name was Droopy.
Droopy. That's right, he was very droopy and I'm going to stab him.
Why don't you attack the fire guy?
I'm going to stab him because he's so far away.
You can get close to him.
You can move.
We do have 36 minutes on the board with 65 skulls.
Oh my god. Yeah, we have like your skull.
Get the big guy.
Highly questioning your.
What are you doing?
All right, fine. Yeah! I'm
Ah, pep talk from Beans. Love it.
Wait, what was that?
Tough
One,
luck.
Two, three, four, five, look. Six.
Yeah, share a square. That's cool.
Share a square.
Share a square.
Right. And remember, flank.
Oh yeah, don't you get an extra point because you're...
An extra two to hit if you are flanking and then an extra 10 damage dealt plus the other damage you have.
Well, I only get six, right? One, two, three, four, five, six. That's as far as I can go.
Okay.
Right? Yes.
Does that count as flanking?
Mm. Yes.
Yes! Yes. Let's do this! Low power!
You don't know if you don't ask.
12 plus my dagger moves is 22.
22.
To Blaze.
Plus two. Including the plus two or not? Did you already add the plus two?
I did not add the plus two.
Then it is a hit!
Yeah! I move to strike Blaze, but I'm throwing daggers over the top of Bone Back Crusher's shoulders, so it's just like a dagger throw toss. It's a five. And three, five, six, seven, eight, plus 10 flanking, so 18.
Woo!
18 damage. Dale, tell us, what
is that plus that six?
Plus another d6.
Roll d6,
got it.
Yellow beans, I'm so glad you're here.
Glad we get to one, so.
Ah, Jesus.
That was
one. There is a cursed dice. Oh, cursed dice, I believe that Buddy is watching from on high, looking after Blaze. Buddy, how are those necromancers doing? Not quite there yet, right, Curious?
Can you repeat that,
Yeah, the necromancer's magics has yet to find Buddy in the temporal realm. More grease on the bone! Rycurius demands it, will you get down there in the eyes of the Godlander? Now, that number was what?
That was, 19 plus what, 20? It was 20 total.
20, not bad. Not bad, but not great. The clock ticks. 34 of the Earth minutes on the clock.
Oh my
god. Turn to the thirstiest of the bunch. I believe it is you now, the Wizard Beans.
All right, so I've got these lightning bolts. I'm going to shoot you, and I'm sorry.
Oh, that's all right.
One, two, three,
Beans
four,
is polite
five,
yet practical.
Yeah, six. So I'm going to get the big guy, and then I'm going to straight line. I'm also going to hit Lyra.
That's all right, take one for the
team. So I've got a d6.
Yeah,
Lyra, pants on fire.
So I've got a
d6. Seriously, no, her pants are on fire.
Well,
now
this
time. So much fire.
4 times 5 is 20.
Lovely. So damage dealt to Lyra, 20. Whose fire pants burned her legs.
Oh no, I'm also going to die.
God damn it, no Lyra!
Hashtag trap times 3. Hashtag Neonet engages the buddy system.
Lyra, as Lyra's blood doth hit the earth, suddenly three traps spring into the realm, but as does...
Wait, that's what she saved by the potion earlier.
Oh, and what is this creature in here?
She is kept...
What is this creature in the lava?
That is the ghost of Zacchaeus trapped inside of a common wood wolf. Zacchaeus has entered the realm, but he has left as quickly as he came. God. And he quickly licked. And Lyra, you are down to just 1 point. Remember, the potion saves you. Thank you, Rykerius, for reminding us. She remains lively. But of course, the body has been summoned.
No.
And
no.
the blood of her burnt pants, it doth hit the air, and the necromancers have pulled their systems. And then suddenly, like the middle of like that movie, D2, The Mighty Ducks, when the Bash Brothers are united once again. Buddy doth enter the realm!
No!
Buddy is back!
No!
No!
Oh,
wait.
Buddy! No, he's back!
Get out of here!
Buddy has returned! Do we do the board thing again? Probably. And they hug each other, and as they hug, they meld into one lava creature, and then they fall into the water, and then it sort of looks like they're lovers, because maybe they are, who knows, maybe they're just best friends who act like lovers, we can't tell, it's very unclear, but they love each other so, and then they quickly melt apart, and they're... Oh, it is dangerous now, because remember, in order to get here, the ghost of Zacchaeus has sent thrice traps into the realm, and the traps are dealt as such. The first goes to Carabag.
No.
The second goes to Beans.
No.
The third of the traps goes maiden, sitting upon death's doorstep, but a wisp of life remains.
Jesus, her legs already.
We don't have legs.
Yes, they are cousins, but as you know, in the gauntlet, people are even more attracted to their cousins than usual.
That is true.
That is very true.
This is very interesting.
We'll talk later.
We'll talk. Ah, a foreign inconvenient pillar does crumble and land upon the back of Caraban. Now, you must speak in an accent for one turn, and all of you are dealt 1d8 plus 5 damage. And so that is 7 plus 5. 13. You are dead.
I'm dead.
13.
I'm dead.
She's dead, and as you see the pillar fall and crumble and hit Caraban, you go, oh no, Caraban! But then one rock, you're so almost dead that one rock just hits you in the head and you go, oh, and you're dead. But I believe, Rykerius, if I am not incorrect.
Yeah, it's like a cute way to die.
There is.
Man, that's a bummer.
Rykerius, can you check the resurrection board?
Yes, I believe we have one left.
One left! Ooh. Quick, Beans, use your magic.
Use a spell, Beans.
Yes, and it works!
Woo!
No,
of course not.
The accent remains. Let's hear the accent.
I know what I'm doing. I'm tricking him and talking like a dumbass.
Ooh, Caraban, silly boy, silly boy. The first of the traps is dealt, and you have died so many times. Did you see anything new? Did you see anything new in the
Well,
outer
I
realms?
Lost my accent, so that was really cool.
Good,
I don't
good.
Know, I was like dipping into the underworld river, and then like just all of a sudden I just, you know, I sound like a...
Gave it to him. Okay.
Yeah, like it was sort of this accent transfer.
As she explains it, suddenly an extra lethal goblin foaming at the mouth does spring forth. And it is Bogath, the cousin of Trogath. And now Beans did use his resurrection spell, trying to sneak out the back like nobody noticed her. The goblin does jump and does 1d12 of damage unless... Oh, no, 1d12 of damage, and it is death unless you can pass a 30 reflex save. Ah! But the potion doth come forth, and Beans is like, show us your deflecting of this trap.
Bye!
Yes,
Beans.
Indeed.
Beans got moved.
She slips by.
She's fine. She doesn't get any points. No damage.
Yeah, no. You well. You take 1d12.
Oh.
Did you?
You pass the death save, but you take 1d12 of death.
D12.
It looks like Eminem and,
sorry.
And five other rappers.
Yes.
You mean just 1 point?
1 point.
Nice.
That's all you
nice
need. 1 point.
Try.
Oh, just one.
Beans
just
don't
one
care.
That's it. Yeah.
Beans don't care. That goblin Bogaf.
BDC.
Worst.
Beans don't care.
It's Bogaf is the cousin that Trogaf does not like to associate with, and he's not attracted to, even though people are more attracted to their cousins in the realm of the gauntlet. It is spoken, it is so, it will be not referenced anymore tonight.
Did you miss that?
Man, he's serious.
Rycurious just was like, why do you say these things? Now, let's keep in mind, the final poisons do come to the resurrected elf, back to full health, but a salty, painful, swinging axe does come, because in the temporal realm.
Jesus, so much.
Buddy was trapped inside of the temporal rift where there was also a realm of all axe people. And inside of his mouth is one last axe and he spits it at you. And it is 2d8 plus 5 damage dealt. So 12 plus 5 is
17. It's like 17.
17.
62 minus 17.
For the master cannot do basic math.
Right
now.
Now,
it's so much
the ghost of Zacchaeus has haunted us, Nomorius, as we move forth into the realm.
Yeah,
but Blaze and Buddy are back to back. Now keep in mind, if you can use your 26 earth minutes well and efficiently and not let the wizard blather with his bladder tongue too much, you can kill them both and get a very high score
count.
Focus upon you, we now turn our sight Beans.
Beans?
Do they have to be put back to back, or how do we?
Should they be back to back?
Should they be back?
Yes, put them next to each other.
Okay, great, great,
back
great
to back. Turn around.
Remember, they were infused as one lava bean.
They're like
but now they are
cousin
two.
Love.
They're buddies. Right. They're like.
But you can only attack one
buddies
at a time unless your weapon.
Take them out.
Other.
Biggest spell.
Okay, so I can shoot a fireball that goes 120 feet forward, no matter what.
Yeah, man.
So and then let's see, what if I get here, can I shoot it that way and I won't hit my friends? Yeah. One,
yes.
Two, three,
aww,
four, five. Great. So I'm right here. I'm going to shoot a fireball. It's going to go through both of them.
Wonderful.
Because they've been merged.
Indeed.
So here we go. We got to roll. Where's my fireball? 6 times 5. Okay.
D6.
Beans in the house.
Beans. Okay. 2 times 5 is 10.
10. 10 dealt to each.
10 to each.
10 dealt to each. It goes right, it gives him a little bit of a bellyache, and he burps up fire that burns Blaze.
Okay.
But the fire damage has been dealt
right
to both. But now, angrily, they deal.
Blaze, can we hurt the people, please?
Yeah, we'll hurt them all, buddy. That's what we'll do. We'll both get an attack. All right, guy? All right, big guy? You're gonna be all right?
Now,
I'm out.
They each attack, and both of their attacks hit all of you.
What?
Not me. I'm invisible, mother.
Yep. All right. All but you.
When does a rainbow shield come into effect?
What does it say?
A rainbow shield reflects one elemental attack back at enemy.
All right. So what it'll do is it's going to reflect it black at
Yes.
Black is going to reflect it back at Blaze, who does, oh my goodness, a 19. Wait, no, hold on. I'm doing this wrong. La la la. Shroom.
Stop blathering, wizard!
Yes. All right, it is a 2.
What the? Oh, good.
16. So 16 damage dealt Blaze to himself, but 16 damage hurt 2-3 of you, except for the one who's invisible. Oh, no, and you who just deflected it.
So just me.
Just the elf. Who's just like, I am back from the, oh!
Literally always dying, it's fine.
Literally
it's fine.
Always dying.
It's fine.
So minus 16 on Blaze.
Both.
Now, don't forget, Buddy, seeing that Blaze has been harmed, looks upon him.
Blaze, don't be afraid.
Now his anger is strong.
Oh shit. We riled him up.
And I rolled for him as well.
Oh no.
He did so. So it was 7 times 3, 21 31 damage dealt to you and to you.
31?
31?
Oof. To her? Again?
Additionally?
Additionally?
She dead.
I'm
dead.
Dead again.
Dead again.
No, we lost Lyra.
We lost Beans and Lyra.
What are we
going to
do?
Two dead.
The
this is not Blade good. Buddy in a blind rage did kill the wizard, did kill the elf.
It's like Lenny.
Yes, it is like that.
Tell me about the rabbits.
It is like that.
Like,
that is like that. That's what the dynamic is like.
Oh, okay.
It's very sad times. Very sad times. Oh. Can they be resurrected? Can we get another subscriber? Or will they have to wait one turn? Quickly, let us move and bring them back alive.
Gotta get this.
The good thing is, the turn is just starting, so this should go quite quickly. Yeah. On to you now.
Here we go.
Okay. Yeah, I'm right in front of the Lays.
Woo!
Subscriber!
Kind Gexatron or Jaxatron, tell us in the chat what it is. Thank you for subscribing to Hyper RPG, a realm full of imagination and darkness and danger. You have entered the gauntlet now. You have given us resurrection magics. Now, let us look to the dice of destiny to see who the magics will befall upon. Will it be the elf? Will it be the wizard?
Beans!
It is. Good sweet mercy. Beans!
Beans!
And she got them fireballs back.
Yes,
beams
with full magic restored. Springs forth back to life.
Nice work, Beans.
Fantastic.
Beans and AJ.
Fantastically, wonderfully.
Now.
Take your turn.
Yeah, Blaze, dude.
Blaze is
take out that Blaze.
I'm all up in front of you with my,
use your fire extinguisher.
With my handles.
Yes, you have two handles.
My handles.
Just kick them in the groin.
Yeah, oh yeah, the handles would be perfect.
Yeah, shove them up in there.
Eight
plus 10.
Plus 10, 18.
Are you flanking?
Yeah, it's not
I'm flanking.
Yeah. And you're going for who, Blaze?
I'm going for Blaze.
It is a miss.
Oh,
what?
Man.
It is a miss. Quick. On to you.
Go!
Timer ticks! All right, timer ticks! Keep the first alive now! Keep your sights set! Get your swords sharpened! For you are in the gauntlet and we are in the last 20 minutes where you could turn this around if you can kill both of these gladiators and all of the minions before you move.
Alright. Oh, man, Blaze. Alright, so I'm gonna move my guy. I moved him over here because we're flanking still. We're on the flank motions. And I got 12 plus 10, 12. 22. Plus two, right?
Play two plus two, flanking. It is a hit.
Yeah, man. Yes. Boom. So I'm gonna take my daggers out and I'm gonna shove them down into Blaze's feet, and I'll pin him down to the ground. Six, seven, eight, six, nine, 19.
Fine hit indeed.
I stabbed those things. Keep him on the floor, man. He ain't going nowhere.
Oh, you ain't going nowhere.
Keep him for the night.
Blaze. It's okay.
It's all right, big guy. See, you attacking yourself.
But I don't want you to be hurt.
Oh, my.
Yeah,
like two cousins riled up by the heat. On to you now.
Come on, Beans.
Beans got her fireball back. She's going to use her
fire.
My fire
with
fire.
Oh,
fire.
So that is 6 times 5. 5 times 5 is 25.
Boom.
And she goes through both of us.
Whoa, the fire dot burns. And the fire is so hot that it gets cold. And inside of Blaze, it does turn all of his insides into ice cubes. And then as he's watching his friend get hurt, Buddy goes,
"Good Blaze is cold."
And then whoa, suddenly the fires within come to him as well and it hurts him. So we move, all right, so it's 25, 25. That is the first hit that's been dealt on to Buddy.
All right. Shit. We need to focus on Buddy too.
But their anger stands.
Uh-oh, get ready, y'all.
Guy. Oh, they're still life in me, I promise. Miss. We'll take another one of them down, I swear we will.
Oh my God, Blaze.
Roll!
Both miss.
Yeah!
Now we have the attacks from the minions. Let's see if they're dealt
as
well.
They're gonna miss too.
Two hit. Two minions hit. The first goes to Caraban, he of the funny speech. The second goes to Backcrusher.
All
right.
Killing rogues. Yes.
And as we are now in a new turn, and the damage that is dealt is...
Man.
The damage that is dealt is... 2, 6.
Six, man! Yes. How about I give them 2 cigarettes and see what they think about that?
You can try.
Man, who wants some smokes?
Sure.
Yeah, all right. Just light them up. There you go. Yeah. It's like prison.
They take the cigarettes and they smoke them, but then their fire is so hot that it spits the fire back onto you and you take an additional...
No! Oh, no!
Oh, damage!
Oh, man, I'm dead!
Okay.
Oh.
No,
oh,
you're
never
smoking
kills!
Smoking
kills. Smoking kills is tricky. Now, keep forward. Keep forward.
We gotta get them.
Keep forward and possibly pull those out. Fantastic. Yeah. Great. It is on to you. And suddenly, it is a new round.
Go, go, go!
I'm gonna get buddy, dude. Screw this guy. Get my handles. I'm gonna do it.
Oh.
Go.
Go.
Okay. Let's go.
Yeah. 7, 10, 17.
Miss.
Miss.
Oh, hey. Miss. On to you, and then suddenly Beans uses their magics. Red
kidney beans!
Yeah. Lyra, alive once more.
Lyra's back.
Just in time to do damage. Can you take down Blaze in this turn? I think you can.
Turn your sights to Blaze.
Get Blaze down.
18!
18 plus 12. It is a hit.
30. Yeah. 30
hits.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes!
30. So roll your d10.
Ow!
Roll your d10.
This is for you, Beans. Thank you.
Oh, well, Charles, welcome back.
Y'all queen.
30.
Plus 9. 3.
3. 3 plus 9. 12.
12.
12.
12. Are you flanking?
We're flanking.
I'm striking.
Are you flanking?
Oh, yeah.
And do you get a flank bonus?
No, she doesn't have a flank.
You don't have a flank bonus? 12. 12 is damage done, but Blaze hangs on.
Oh, man.
For as he was almost dead, Buddy picks him up in his arms.
Don't worry, Blaze.
Get him.
I'll make sure you're okay.
Are you dead?
Thanks, big guy. Just remember, I'll find you again in another realm.
When you die, you'll be part of me.
Okay, I've got one fireball left.
Great.
You're dead, right?
I'm dead.
You're dead?
Yeah.
This is my last fireball.
Oh, wait, use it well.
So
now keep in mind that they are holding each other. So in this attack, you will hit them both. Yes, your magics have been strong tonight.
2 times 5 is 6.
Blaze is dead!
Boom!
Yes.
Bye, Blaze. You'll be part of me now.
So in that moment, Buddy breathes in Blaze into him.
Uh-oh.
But now he is dead, and he's part of an angered Buddy who has just come back from the realm from the necromancers and is furious that his friend is dead. We now see how many skulls, the d20 3 times to put skulls on the board. Can you get us over 100?
Oh, 9.
9! Again.
Oh, 3 times. Let's do it. 2.
Oh.
8.
So it is 19.
Yeah.
19 skulls to the board! Furious!
Beans!
Beans! No!
Super furious. He only turns his fires to you.
Uh-oh, Beans.
Oh, no.
You got full health, though.
And he rolls a natural 1. It is nothing. He is so sad and consumed.
It's a big old dummy.
So consumed with sadness.
She got that protein from that bean.
She got them legumes.
No!
But don't forget the minions.
Oh, no. Oh,
miss.
2 of them hit.
Oh, crap.
2 of the minions hit.
How did I die? I was invisible.
You used it already.
Oh, you only used it once?
Yeah.
Man, that's crazy.
The first attack. The attack goes to Backcrusher and Lyra.
Yes.
The damage that is dealt
3.
Is 3 and 6.
6.
3 and 6 damage dealt.
Wait. Who? Beans or me?
You. 3, 6.
3. Okay.
You're safe.
I'm still good.
Well, I know, but I'm trying to
14 minutes. We can do it now. Just focus your sights onto Buddy. Put him down.
14
to the
minutes
ground.
On Buddy's butt.
Okay, whose turn is it?
We're back to the beginning.
Okay, my turn.
And I'm alive again.
Woo! Are you? Yes!
I think so, right? I can come back.
Oh, yeah.
New round.
New turn.
Yeah,
boom!
I'm gonna new turn. Yeah,
new
I'm
turn.
Gonna
yeah,
get
back
Buddy. Screw you, Buddy. What is that?
6.
16.
16, miss.
Miss, whatever.
Man.
Miss.
Lyra,
hit it.
All right, are we going for minions?
Hit it and quit it.
No,
man, we gotta kill Buddy.
We
gotta kill Buddy.
Buddy. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. 5.
5 plus 12.
12 is 17.
17.
Miss.
Man, it's a miss. All right, man, I'm going to throw some daggers at his face.
Throw daggers.
So I got
15 plus 10 is 25. 25 is a hit.
Boom, yes. Baby. All right, I'm gonna take some daggers and I'm gonna like stab him in his eyeballs. I got 4 plus 4, 5, 6, 7 plus 10 is 17.
17 damage dealt. What does it do to the creature?
What it does is he starts to bleed lava out of his eyeballs, they congeal, so he can't see because the buddy goes blind from me stabbing him in the eyes, and that's that.
What is that?
Now he is stumbling around, he can't see a darn thing. On to you, Beans.
Okay,
you
Beans has to move a little bit so that she can do, Okay, so now we gotta do a lightning bolt. So this is I'm gonna blow up everything in these four squares, but look, I moved, so it's just gonna get him. Okay, so now lightning bolt is...
Awesome.
6 times 5. Oh, same thing. Okay.
Thanks for thinking of us, Beans.
3 times 5 is 15.
Yep.
15! You have heard the creature, the blinded, tiny, thing. Now, what does it do to him?
Okay, it locks all of his joints. He can't bend any of his joints.
He can't see, he can't move, but he can still emit heat and fire, and he does so to all of the party.
Oh no!
Attack to hit,
dumb buddy.
19. It is a miss.
Woo! Yes!
How many minions are left in there?
It's getting hot.
It looks like there
one,
are.
One, two.
It's because we're
three
in the lava room.
Yeah.
Is that a minion? Is that us?
That's not.
That's us?
No, that's not us.
Oh, no. 1, 2, 3, 4.
4.
Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That guy.
5. Keep in mind that you can also kill them. And that
well,
will
I know, but we
want to
get that one guy.
All right, so, but yeah, focus your sights on Buddy.
Yeah, concentrate on Buddy. Screw the
concentrate on him, but get them too, because they're easy skulls.
They hurt you too.
So two of them hit. Two of these minions hit.
Two minions hit.
The first hits Lyra. The second hits Caravan.
Man.
The damage that is done.
Always us.
One and one. Just one and
one.
Good,
if you guys kill him, I can kill these two with that same thing, the lightning bolt.
All right.
If you strike, if you all strike true and proud and swiftly, you can kill him in this round.
All right, you. It's my turn.
Yeah.
All right.
But if you cannot,
just I'm like going Marshall. For Buddy, guys. Get all right. I'm not gonna. I can only have my handles to work with, so this is what it's gonna be. Come on, Jesus.
12 plus 10, 22.
22. And are you flanking?
Yeah.
Are they?
But do I have the flanking? Do I?
We haven't moved.
Anybody has
flanking. We've just been going.
You have 10 is flanking.
No. But is that damage?
There is no flanking. It's a miss.
Oh.
It's a miss.
Wait, did you take your, did you move?
I was still in front, dude.
He died. We gotta get closer.
Get closer?
Yeah. We kill Blaze.
You have 10 minutes on the clock. I'll allow for a flank. Get in there, get in the position.
Get that flank.
Are you flanking? I can't see.
Yeah,
we're flanking.
All right, great.
Bad guy.
All right, it's gonna be like a set, like back to back.
There they are. They're on two different squares.
Yeah, with Lyra.
No, it's gonna be like a sandwich.
Wait, she's not sandwiched.
You're allowed to do it. I'm gonna allow a flank. We have 10 minutes left. It's plus 2 to hit. It is a hit.
Hit.
Go. Roll the damage.
Roll that dash. Man, make that buddy pay.
4 plus 3. 7.
Plus 10.
Plus 17.
17 damage dealt. Tell us, what does it do?
Let's see. It just. He just falls down to his knees and falls flat in his face. He can't really move or anything because the beans.
His joints,
He's just joints, and he is just, cannot see. He's just face down. Dude.
Poor buddy. He is but a flailing ball of fire, still hot to touch. Now, on to you, Lyra. Use your elven magic. You have been knocked down again and again in this game, but you may stand and you may do damage.
Ooh, girl.
Natural one. It is a miss. Moving on. Caravan.
All right, I'm going to turn around.
Let's go.
I'm going to turn around and take out this this weird looking bug creature. It's like a one. There we go. It's like an aardvark.
Kill him.
All right.
Kill him.
An aardvark. His name is Arty.
Ooh, 16. Arty.
I got 16.
16.
Plus
yes.
10.
Hit. Hit. Roll for damage. Right.
I'm gonna move. And I'm gonna jab my daggers in his butt.
6. Dead. You have killed it.
Yes.
Stay and remove it. Roll for skulls.
Roll for skulls.
4 skulls.
4 skulls.
Woo! We're so close to 100.
Boom,
oh my
baby.
God.
Beans.
Let's go. Beans.
To
you. Hit it, Beans.
Beans. Let's hear it. Beans. Beans. Beans.
But it's all I got, honestly.
You are going for the minions or for the
buzzer? And this will be my last one. I'm going for the big guy.
Gotta go for it.
But I'm also gonna hurt Lyra and who's that? Is that you back?
That's back.
That's
back,
me.
Back.
Right, so you're hurting, gonna hit
that's fine. You're hurting your friends.
Okay,
us.
Look at this. So, but 6 times 5 is 20. And that's my last of the
6 times 5 is 25.
6 times 5 is 20. 30.
Math is hard for all of us, especially me. Math is hard. I'm sure that there's a collection of gauntlet clips where it's just leaving like a 1 plus 1 is 2. I don't care. All right, it's closed. It is a harm done. And you guys took the 30 damage as well.
30
each?
Sorry, I'm good. So sorry.
I'm dead. I'm done.
Dead.
I don't know what to do. He's so
dead.
Desperation.
We'll get him. Beans has killed. Who still remains?
I'm still alive.
Good. Okay. Buddy is furious and sends. He's flailing around like a little child in a nursery who doesn't want to pick up his toys. He turns his attack to all. 11 plus 9, 20. It misses all of you.
Yeah.
However, the minions that remain.
Just like a missile crashes.
The minions that remain.
Okay.
One minion hits, and it is, you know, the ugly one. And it hits upon you.
Even though I'm dead?
Oh, you're dead?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Batcrush is dead.
Backrusher's dead. It hits Lyra.
Of course.
Two.
Two.
Okay. Damage dealt.
It's only two, girl.
She's okay. It's good. I'm hanging.
You got
in there.
This.
All right, roll.
Seven Earth minutes
here we
remain.
Go. Here we go.
Turn your sight to Blaze. Put him down.
Just,
yeah. Buddy, put him down.
Okay, I'm still going to go for this thing.
Yeah. I say go for Blaze.
You're going longsword?
Go for longsword. Longsword.
17.
17.
Plus 12.
Plus 12.
Hit.
Woo!
Hit.
All right. Damage.
18. By a thread.
You know
moving.
You have to
this is your moment. This is your moment, Caliban.
Come on, Caliban.
Caliban. Are you flanking?
I'm flanking.
No, go.
No, you're flanked. Because you're sandwiched.
Oh, you're like
a sandwich.
Right? Because there's a rogue, and you're in the middle.
Okay. So we need a sandwich hit. Like.
No, we sandwich.
Okay,
sandwich
we're fine. I feel like it's
sandwich
a good
beans.
Sandwich.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we have a
see
flanking
that?
Bonus.
Flanking bonus.
Flanking. 4 plus 10 is 14.
Miss.
Damn it!
Beans, just do it.
My lies.
Just do it.
Blowing up everybody. Wait, I don't have any more fire. Okay, this is the cone one now.
Use
so this
your
is
weakest
burning
spell.
Hands.
Icy Ray.
Use your weakest spell.
Oh, wait.
Yeah,
just Icy Ray?
Missile. Use Icy.
I'm gonna do that one. Just roll what?
Use it. D6 minus 1.
Oh. So D6. D6 minus 1. Do it.
That's all you need. Roll D6. Roll D6.
Five
at
4.
He's dead! Boom! How he dies. You have 5 minutes on the board.
Oh.
Roll.
Okay. A cold gust of wind enters the room. 17.
Good roll.
Everybody goes completely still for a moment. 16.
Good roll.
And then there's a loud crash, and everybody turns to like, what happened when we look back? He is no more. 15.
Oh, 15. 48 to the board. 48 to the board. Now, you have slain him. Now.
So now what do we have in here?
Slay the remaining. But of course, 5 minutes remain. But suddenly, you are not just in the realm of lava. You are in the realm of Vidarax, the time bender.
Yeah.
Vidarax steps forward.
You have destroyed my children, and now, not out of vengeance, for I cared not for them, I shall just destroy you myself.
Vidarax has entered. Now, Vidarax is a dangerous creature indeed. I would suggest with the time that is allowed to kill the minions first, but if you are able to be swift and true, you may also potentially kill Vidarax and get an even higher score. If you are out there is 4 minutes that remain. If you can send them any potion, custom potion, be it, you can get them to potentially get that skull count higher. Don't you love them?
What are we gonna do, guys? What are we gonna do? Get the minions or are we gonna do Vidarax?
I feel like some of us need to go.
No, we need to do it as a team.
Kill whoever you can. I would suggest killing the minions first,
yeah,
because they are guaranteed pretty easy kill.
Okay,
I'm dead. Go. Oh,
I'm dead.
Me!
Oh,
sure. She's
no,
one.
She's back.
Resurrected.
Resurrected.
You all got resurrected.
Yeah, man.
Okay,
better than
I'm resurrected.
Hinduism.
Okay. I'm gonna do, let's see.
Okay.
Crap. Where am I? 1, 2, 3, 4.
You can kill that guy.
Yeah, kill that guy.
Wait, which one?
Green guy.
Oh, okay, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, that's a 1.
There we go. Great. I'm gonna kill this green guy. Got my handle now, guys.
Luperio steps forth.
15
plus 10.
Hits.
25.
Hits.
Boom.
Hit.
Roll damage.
Got that.
Damage. Got my handles in his face.
Yes, girl.
One. Plus 3.
4.
Miss.
No. Damn it.
Lives.
No, that was 4 damage.
Got 4 damage.
4 mat damage. Oh. Lives.
Yeah.
No.
I think it's. Where's the closest minion to me?
That guy.
The same guy.
Anyone that is not Vidarax the Time Mender, see what the clock ticks. It ticks like the sands
16.
On the beach.
16 plus 12 is
hit.
28. Hit.
Hit. You got it.
Damage. This one.
Yep.
Oh,
10. 10.
Oh,
10. Dead.
It's 10.
Dead.
10 plus 9. 19.
19. 19.
Dead. Roll for skulls.
Skulls.
Yeah, we got that, man.
Skulls. Skulls. Oh, boy.
Four.
Four.
Boom.
Four
skulls.
Four skulls.
Four skulls to the Lord, Raikunis.
Boom.
Woo.
Cataban, okay. On to you.
All right.
Go.
It's too far for me to go, so I'm just going to teleport and move anywhere into the dungeon.
All right.
Use my potion real quick.
Go as you wish and travel as you might, for when time doth stop, perhaps you can get a little tickle.
Boom.
A little
All right.
tickle before you All right. sleep.
Using some daggers on the winged creature here, the winged ant dragon.
Have you already done damage to that one, though?
Damn it. No, I missed him earlier.
Oh.
I did 2 plus 10 is 12.
Awesome. Miss.
I missed.
Crap.
Miss.
I moved, though.
Wizard.
Beans, let's do
okay.
this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6.
Yeah.
Okay, so
yeah.
Now I'm doing the cone. So I'm gonna hit you, but I'm gonna hit all
Do
three
it.
Of them.
Take them out. I got
okay,
power.
Okay, and I have 2. One this one. So then I have 1 left after this. So I have to do a D4 times
out
5.
Time is running out.
2 times 5 is
10.
10.
10.
And I hit 10. Big guy and both wasps and also you.
It's good for me.
You have plucked the 2 thumbnails off of Vidarax.
Yes.
Yeah. And I was able to spare them. 10 damage is dealt to all of them, and then how many of the minions did you get?
2.
2.
2, and they are slain dead.
They are? Oh.
Slain dead.
Both of them?
Yeah, girl.
Yes. Okay.
Beans.
Beans.
No,
yeah, beans.
Get some skulls.
3. 1.
4 skulls in the board!
Hey. One more little guy. One more little guy. Hide behind
the
cauldron.
Wait, which
one? You got a little guy.
My turn?
Okay.
1 minute remains.
Okay,
Vidarax turns his sight. He is a miss. It is a miss. Now onto you, quickly.
Yeah. Yeah.
A minute remains. A minute.
Go.
Oh,
2.
Minute.
He missed.
Minute.
Yeah, he missed us.
Okay, let's do it. I'm gonna go to.
No, go to little guys.
Little guy.
1,
yeah,
2,
little guys.
Little guy.
Vidarax is just filing his nails.
Around there.
She got it. We got it.
Got my daggers.
Got it,
handles.
14 plus 10. Plus 10.
Hit.
24.
Hit. Damage.
Damage.
2 plus 3 is 5.
5.
Dead.
Yes!
Roll for skulls.
Skulls.
4
skulls.
Oh,
yes, okay. I want to do, where's the closest minion?
This guy. All minions
You're
are
done.
Gone.
Oh, we have to
get tons of Vidarax.
Oh, okay. 12.
12.
10 is 22.
22?
Yeah.
Plus
7,
right
plus
22,
9
22,
it was
a
miss.
Oh.
Oh. No, you're flanking it. Take it as a hit. Take it as a hit.
Okay, so 9 plus 7 is 16.
16 damage dealt. Now onto you, Caravan.
Yep, that's the wrong one. I'm going to...
Hurry!
Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Go! We got
13
seconds!
Wait,
that's the wrong die. Is it? No, it's not.
Yeah. Wait, this one. 7 seconds.
14 plus... it's 24.
24. Then this one.
No, it's this one.
Four. Beans, roll 1 more hit.
Okay, so all I've got left, okay, so this is times 5, so 4 times 5 is 20.
Minus 20. And while you have harmed and removed 2 of the fingers, Vidarax remains. And the game is done. The game is done!
Man, we championed pretty hard.
The game is done. And Vidarax lives on. Blaze and Buddy have been united again, and you guys, your skull count is not a bad skull count. 144 is actually a pretty good count. Am I right, Vicurious?
I mean, it's not the worst.
It is not the worst. It's not the best. It is not the best. But it
You're
is
not
the
best.
I'm not. I'm truly not.
Some sassy beans over here.
Ah, thank you, Raikurius. He knew that I was trying to fish that out of him. He knew it. He knew it very well. Everyone, they have fought valiantly. They have fought proudly. And while they may not be the team, what was the name of your team?
Beans.
Beans.
The team known as Beans.
Beans team.
Beans team.
Beans team.
While they may not all return as a unit in the battle of the fight against Kratikus Raktok right now, take you to the magic mirror where you will vote upon who is the MVP, the most valorous participant, and that person will return. The most valorous participant will return for the wild card round, which will be happening within the next few months, all leading up to our battle against the hordes of Kratikus Raktok who do march upon the lower lands every day. He has just taken the town of Rahu, and the town of Rahu was eviscerated from top to bottom. But for now, the gauntlet has been dealt, the blood has been spilled, and the... Whoa! Hey guys, how's it going? I'm Chris Bramante. Thank you for watching The Gauntlet. I was him the whole time. Because what you're watching is just pretend, it's just make-believe. Can't you tell by all the people and all the posters in the background? I hope you couldn't. And if you couldn't, it means we were doing our job right. Now, The Gauntlet is here every single Thursday at 6:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. That is in the city of California, on Hyper RPG's Twitch channel. Thank you guys so much. Thank you to all of the new subscribers that we got during this thing. We had some C-Team crossover. Welcome, guys. Thank you for joining us down here on the G-Team, The Gauntlet. Now, if you want to find more from me, Amontioc, you can find me as Amontioc on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. You can find me with musical improv group, Robot Teammates. Woo! You can find me with Buffy Podcast, the Sunnydale Study Group. We have a panel at WhedonCon for everybody that is in the Southern California area. It is an all Joss Whedon Con, because we're all a bunch of freaking nerds. Can't you tell from playing all this Pathfinder? Now, let's find out who all these fine friends were playing these characters. Everybody, who are you? Tell them where they can find you.
I am Marisol Ferrar. You can find me on Geek & Sundry on Ready Becco every Monday, and find me on Twitter at Noventry.
Noventry, lovely, lovely, lovely. All right, next lady, who is that? Who is that elf?
Hey, I'm Kate Parkin. I am on Instagram and Twitter at Katherine Parkin, K-A-T-H-E-R-I-N-E. And then I'm on YouTube, I'm Weasley Sweaters. I make Harry Potter musical parodies. And so you can find
she
me.
She is amazing.
So find me on the YouTube.
He is awesome. Yeah. Yes, indeed. You, sir.
Hi, I'm Zach Rowland. I'm new to California, so I'm just kind of building my presence here. But you can find me on Twitter at Zprov, or probably the same at Instagram or whatever. I do stupid stuff on there. Why not? Ooh.
Awesome. Lovely, lovely. And who dat?
Hi girl, I'm Scout Durwood. You can find me on all the social medias at Scout Durwood. And guys, I have an album that is available for pre-sale today.
Yes!
Today.
Awesome.
It'll be available across the board on May 19th on iTunes, etc. But if you get it now, you get 2 instant downloads plus a pretty hip I'm with the Dog rainbow t-shirt only available with your pre-order.
Awesome. Where can they find the album?
That you can pre-order. You have to go to Blue Elan, which is the label B-L-U-E, new word E-L-A-N, or you can follow me anywhere, and I'm blasting the pairs out of that as of tonight. We just found out today that we're available for pre-sale.
So. Awesome, awesome.
You're the first to know.
Yes, and mods, if we can get the link to Scout's album in the chat, that would be awesome.
Nice.
Guys, get her stuff. She's awesome. We were in a Craigslist musical together.
Yes.
That was very fun. Yes, it was awesome. Scout is awesome. They are all awesome. And then these guys, speaking of Harry Potter stuff, these two were so kind as to be part of my Hufflepuff crew and Hufflepuff podcast. Yes. And now, before we say ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta, I'm going to get right curious on the board to tell us what's happening with the rest of the weekend, because there's a pretty special event happening. Right here is get in here talking to my chest.
My favorite part of the day. All right, guys, what's up? That was another awesome episode of The Gauntlet. Thank you all once again.
Yay.
You were amazing. Not your score. You guys were great. The score was awesome. Okay. Guys, get ready for tomorrow, though. It is the start of our 48-hour charity drive here at Hyper RPG. It's going to be nuts. There's going to be like over 24 hours of tabletop RPGs, and we're kicking off the day with something totally weird. At 11 a.m. tomorrow, PDT, we're going to be joined by Jennifer Hale and Aaron Fitz for a improvised narrative with you guys where you control the robot's voice as we deal with the fallout. Don't worry. Come close.
Guys, Lucas is playing Conan the Barbarian.
That's happening.
It's gonna be awesome. What?
For some reason, Lucas sacrificed the world because he couldn't deal with his robot girlfriend, and we're gonna explore the fallout
but
together.
But he was smart enough to lock his consciousness inside of a plastic doll and start waking up other consciousnesses, which will be played by Jennifer Hale and Aaron Fitz, to help now right the wrong of the robot uprising. makes total sense.
And I thought you were gonna say to raise money for the Halo Foundation.
Well, that too.
Yeah, that's even better. So we last year raised $67,000, and we're gonna try to double it this year.
Wow.
So we are gonna be doing everything we can. 100% proceeds go to charity, and hope you guys will be there. And after that, of course, we'll be playing games with tons of friends. Akeem, Matt Haley, Orion, Matt Acevedo, Cat Sly, Chris Morante, Yumi Warlock, so many other people are gonna be playing games with us, and of course we got ERVR with special guests, Ashley Esquada, I believe, Esqueda? I'm gonna say it wrong every time. I apologize now, Ashley. And Steph Woodburn is gonna be co-hosting
with
Iffy.
Awesome.
And after that, guys, it's gonna be Death from Above. Our Marauders and the Renegades are gonna be facing off in a battle no one predicted. What happened? We'll find out. And as well, of course, Pencils and Parsecs is going to be happening. And Dan Casey is going to be our special guest for the night. And as well, after that, starting in the 12 a.m. time, we're going to have OVA, our anime RPG. And then it's going to keep going from there. But that's Friday. It's crazy. Get ready, guys. It's going to be for the Halo Foundation. It's going to be a great time. We'll see you tomorrow.
We will see you tomorrow, guys. See you then. See you around the weekend. I'll see you at, I believe, 4 a.m. We're doing a reading of Surf Ninjas. That'll be crazy. But until then, thank you for joining us in the journey! Woo-hoo!